from Palm Desert, California. Game two of the 2023 Calder Cup Finals between the Hershey Bears and the Coachella Valley Firebirds is moments away. Thanks for being with us on Fox 43's coverage of the Calder Cup playoffs in Hershey Bears hockey with Fox 43's Andrew Calista. I'm the voice of the Bears, Zach Fish. Welcome to our fans as well. Tuned in on NBC Sports Washington. At Acrisure Arena for Game 2, Game 1 did not go as planned, Andrew, for the Hershey Bears. A 5-0 loss to Coachella Valley. They were as advertised. We'll talk about the Bears bouncing back here today. We knew Coachella Valley was good, and they really flexed their muscles on home ice in Game 1.
They did every opportunity they had. We've seen a few of these performances before, and every single time, look no further than the Rochester series, Hunter Shepard and the Hershey Bears have responded with a victory.
Take me right into our second point here. Prime example. There's no reason to worry right now for the Hershey Bears. One game does not make a series. It's a great time of year. It's summer. Hershey Park is open 7 days a week. They got an all-new roller coaster, Wildcats Revenge. And on top of that, the Bears are still playing hockey in June. And being down 1-0 the series isn't anything to panic about against Rochester. They lost on home ice 5-1. They bounced back with a victory in game number two, won 4 of the next 5, en route to winning the Eastern Conference Championship. This has kind of been the team's MO all year, resiliency of this squad.
Absolutely. And you mentioned Wildcats Revenge. That's what the Calder Cup playoffs and the Calder Cup finals are all about. Twists and turns, up and downs, gut-wrenching emotions some nights, and enthusiastic energy on another night. More often than not, the Hershey Bears have had the energy and the jump to get the job done.
Well, they're going to need a little bit more offense here today, and we do have a couple lineup changes for the Bears. Ethan Frank is going to be back in the lineup. He has not scored a goal in the Calder Cup playoffs, just 2 assists, but he's a 30-goal scorer in the regular season. You need him not only to step up here hopefully today, but that speed and jump will certainly help.
Well, you mentioned the speed. Definitely a boost right there for the Bears. And, hey, no better time to finally light the lamp for the first time in the playoffs for Ethan Frank than doing it right here. Hopefully it's an early goal to get some of those juices flowing for the Bears.
Todd Nelson thought the Bears made a lot of things that were preventable and changeable as far as mistakes go, things they weren't doing really since Christmas that they've gotten out of their game that were back in game one. They also make a change on defense as Vincent Iorio goes in. This Bears team, the coaching staff, very experienced. They made a ton of adjustments. Expect a lot better effort here tonight.
Absolutely. They kept saying they have more to give. We have more to give, and they will give more tonight. On that, dump and chase. Look for an improved forecheck from the Hershey Bears here tonight as they keep the puck away from netminder Joey DeCord.
DeCord with a shutout in game number one. The Bears look to keep it away from him, and we got puck drop coming up next. Game two of the Calder Cup Finals coming at you. You're watching Hershey Bears hockey on Fox 43.
The GMC Sierra with hands-free driving. Yeah, it rocks. Or did 0.9% APR plus over 1,200 trade assistance and no monthly payments for 90 days on Sierra 5.3-liter V8 light-duty models.
The NBA 2K League is here, and you can catch the best NBA 2K players in the world live and in person at District E. Watch as the top 16 teams in the NBA 2K League face off in the tip-off tournament, the first of 3 5-on-5 tournaments in the NBA 2K League's Banner Chain Series, where the winners will walk away with $250,000 in prize money. Catch the esports action in person at District E, June 14th through the 17th.
You can't buy a best friend. You can love them, pet them, care for them, whether they want you to or not. You can take a picture, you can jump, yell, you can fly to the moon, travel the world, or just stay in bed. You can't buy a best friend like that, but you can adopt one. 'Cause we're connected.
The first period of Hershey Bears hockey on Fox 43 is presented by Abel & Son Roofing and Siding.
on the Highmark Bears Radio Network, AHL TV, the Capitals Radio Network, and welcome to our fans watching on Fox 43.2 Antenna TV and NBC Sports Washington. With Andrew Kalista, I'm Zach Fish, bringing you the action tonight in Acrisure Arena. The Firebirds took game one, 5-0. The Bears look to avenge it tonight. Let's tune in down below for our national anthem as we get set to drop the puck in the desert.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fights, o'er the ramparts we watched, were so gallantly streaming. In the rocket's red glare, the bombs
another sold-out crowd at Acrisure Arena in Palm Desert, California. Game two of the Calder Cup Finals about to get underway. With Fox 43's Andrew Kalista, I'm Zach Fish, bringing you the action tonight. It's the Bears, the Firebirds in game two. And Andrew Hershey looking to get back on track. He'll turn to Hunter Shepherd in net once again. He is seemingly always bounced back in this Calder Cup playoffs.
We've seen it more than one time. Every time that Shepherd does not have his A-plus game, he always responds with an A-plus effort. That's what the Bears are expecting tonight, and they need it.
They'll need some offense, too. You can't win if your goaltender doesn't get any goal support. Hershey looking to get on track offensively after being blanked in game one. Joey DeCord starts for Coachella Valley. Cody Beach, number 45. Brandon Schrader, number 46, your referees. Ryan Jackson, number 84. Dan Kelly, number 98, the linesman. This building is electric. The Bears want to play spoiler and come back home tied 1-1. Game two of the Calder Cup Finals is underway. On the road, you're tuned in to Hershey Bears Hockey. Shepherd up the near side boards. The Bears in the white sweaters, chocolate and cream accents. Classic colors for the HL's oldest franchise against the newest team, the Firebirds, in navy blue, red, orange, and aqua accents as icing is called on Hershey. And a faceoff coming up in their defensive zone. Shepherd in the playoffs has played in every game for Hershey, a record of 10-4 with a 2.09 goals against average. DeCord has played every second. There he is, Joey DeCord, a record of 13-7 with a 2.26 goals against average, his second shutout of the playoffs in game one. Draw to the right of Shepherd. Everyone backed off in the circle. Coming in to take the faceoff, Cole Lind instead of Alex True. True, a goal scorer in game number one. As the Bears take possession of the faceoff, Morelli back on a line, reunited here today with Riley Sutter and Beck Malenstein. He moved up in the lineup with Ethan Frank being on the outside looking in. Evans hit hard. Malenstein winds up falling down to the process. And the puck comes loose defensively to Brogan Rafferty in his own zone. Firebirds with it up the middle, intercepted by Borgstrom, delayed offside. Bears And Lynn with a free pass in his own zone. Coach Todd Nelson's squad changing. Nelson, the three-time Calder Cup champion, is good as anybody at making adjustments. Has a shot on Shepard, short side, is flexed away. Bears defending here up the right boards. Jimmy Schultz, the defender, St. Cloud Stink, but working in behind the goal. Traffic in front of Shepard. Johansson clearing the net. The shot never makes it through. And Ethan Frank back in the lineup to center, and look for him to be playing some inspired hockey tonight.
He's got to be hungry. He wants the puck on his tape, and I feel that he is motivated to put one in the back of the net, Fish.
Puck deflected up and out of play and into the crowd for a whistle. Here's the chance for the Firebirds. A quick dump in. You see them win the battle behind the net. Just a shot. Looked like McCormick maybe hit the side of the net. Not even sure if Shepard got a piece of it. But Firebirds are always dangerous and opportunistic.
Always dangerous, but I like a puck. Shepard able to get a deflection, make a save early on.
See on that second look, Shepard did in fact get a piece. The first shot of the game with the Firebirds. Tripping over his own feet, falling down for Coachella Valley. Cameron Hughes allows the Bears to get it to center. Turn it over, brought it over the blue line. Ponorowski right wing, throwed into the net. Blocked by Aaron Nass, his former teammate in Providence. Well, the Firebirds get it back, just underway. 0-0, 100 seconds into this game. Bad turnover by the Bears in front. Froden has it, stabs it to the net. Broken up by Nass. And the Bears a little helter-skelter in front of their goal. Will take it back defensively. Kennison will fire it forward. Shepard out to play it for Hershey. Sets it up behind the goal. An outlet for Gabriel Carlson to Joe Snively at the center red line. Tries to flip it in. Hit a body. Could not get it deep. Austin Pagansky gets in the way. And the Firebirds dump it behind the Bears zone. And go for the dump and chase style. Shane Wright behind the goal. One of the top prospects in all of hockey. Beneath the goal line, looking to take the puck free. So the fans cheer on the home team here. They've won five in a row on home ice. The Bears losing their first game of the playoffs on the road in game one after starting 6-0. Firebirds to center. They're tripping over their own feet out there. Pagansky falls down again as the Bears break to center. Alexei Protas, their leading scorer, over the blue line and a sideband rush. Spins the middle, leaves for Protas, left circle. Passes off the mark to Johansson. Good luck, but not executed well. Protas gets it back. Goal line feed, and it's a short side shot. Where to go? DeCord's got it underneath him. It's up on top of his blocker. He didn't even know he made the save. As Annis trying to just bank one in off of him. But that's what we've seen there, Andrew, from the Bears team. That's a good odd man rush. But Protas' pass was just a bit off, and then here's the chance from Annis right after.
Yeah, that pass from Protas, couldn't get it on the tape. Annis, though, with that quick wrister, we've seen it time and time again. You don't think you're going to score from that, but a deflection off the back, sometimes it squeaks through.
Draw to the right of DeCore, and less than 3 minutes into this game. That should be credited as a shot on goal for Annis. They have not put it up on the video board yet. Off the draw, they win it right to Annis. He'll shoot, block Protas on the rebound. Goes to the net front. Ranker Evans gets a stick on it. He had three helpers in game number one. Protas to Annis. He'll snap a shot, deflected off the crossbar. A shot in front. LaPierre may have got a piece off the top of the bar and out. Great work by the Bears' third line, but the puck back to center. He'll tag up and go to work again. Now they'll change as LaPierre gets it deep, and that's the type of play the Bears need.
That's what Coach Todd Nelson was talking about. Traffic in front. Make it hard for Joey DeCord to see that puck.
Steal at center by Morelli allows the Bears to rank it behind their own net. Best chance of the game. Doesn't even count as a shot. Off the crossbar and out. Sam Annis really has a lot of jump in this one. Puck dumped in. That's a good dump in. Keeping it away from DeCord was one of them. You get it up on the glass, he can't play it easily. Sutter, far side, throws a check, disrupts the puck. Riley playing that hard-nosed style. They get it to Malenstein, the slot. He shoots off the glove of DeCord. After a juicy rebound and a big hit by McElrath on the right wing. Bears get the puck. Sutter's drive into the glove of DeCord, and he will hold it. But the Bears have come to play, and the rough stuff starts. Less than 4 minutes in, Morelli in front, causing a disturbance as the hard-hitting Bears create some turnovers.
Fish, just before puck drop, I saw somebody wearing a Tommy Wilson jersey, and I said to him, if I don't hear some teeth chattering early on in this one, I'm going to be disappointed. I am not disappointed. Dylan McElrath with a big hit. Beck Malenstein with a big hit, as you see the flick on net and a rebound. Mason Morelli bringing the 84 lumber to say he's here to play.
Face off to the left of DeCord. Bears looking for a sweet start here in this one. 3 minutes and 54 seconds in. They've got four shots on goal and some real quality opportunities. Now the top line is out there. They win the faceoff for the blue line. Iorio's drive blocked in front. And it's skipped away from Ethan Frank. Give it away to Borgstrom, though. Firebirds under duress here are turning the puck over early. Mike Vecchione with it behind the goal. Trying to take it free. Frank on the forecheck, but it's Evans. And will settle the pace behind the goal. Flipped off the glass to center. Clear to the blue line. Borgstrom to Frank. And it's Vecchione that comes up with it instead. Down the right wing. Could not get through three guys in blue. Evans on the breakup to center, where Pilon quickly cuts it off. Bears are hungry on pucks early in this one. 0-0, though, looking for the game's first goal. Puck towards the front of the net of the Bears, taken by Snively. And behind the goal, it's Iorio. He missed five games with an injury, considered day-to-day. Back in there tonight. Snively by himself at center, waiting for some secondary support. He gets it to Beanlock. McMichael charges the net. They hit Ness. Scooting in, right wing. Quick passing play, a delayed penalty call. Coming up on Coachella Valley. Extra attacker is on. Shepherd off. For this extra skater, it's Riley Sutter. Back to the point. Bears controlling the play, looking for their first goal to Calder Cup Finals. And Sutter with it on the right wing, leaves for Ness. Far side corner and Sutter to the goal line. McMichael mishandles, and the puck is touched up long enough for a holding penalty to be assessed by referee Brandon Schrader.
Excellent opportunity here coming for the Chocolate and White. We've already seen a lot of jump from them. Here you see the hold on Joe Snively right there, trying to break it up. Bears doing a good job with puck possession there to get the extra attacker on the delayed call.
Well, Hershey could not. They'll go to work here. Head coach Dan Bylsma, the former Pittsburgh Penguin, Stanley Cup winning coach, looks on. His team down a man for the first time tonight. The Bears power play goes to work. It is 0-0 game, looking to draw first blood. Face off to the Firebirds up the near boards. Protis gets it to Sam Annis on the right wing. One goal in the playoffs with a power play. Leads for Logan Day. Back far boards to the veteran Annis. Day last circle. Frank has got it. He'll shoot right into the chest of DeCord. Wrist shot from Frank. He's got a heavy one. Moves it quickly, but right off that Firebird logo.
He may not have had the pinpoint accuracy that he wanted on this, but as Mitch Lamoureux said, it was quick. He didn't hesitate, and that's how Ethan has to play tonight.
Now Frank back on the power play, led the club with 9 power play goals in the regular season. Nice shrug with the right arm. Day to hold it in for a moment, but cleared by the Firebirds and down the ice. Puck cleared all the way back behind the Bears' net. It's picked up by Day, and he'll look to escape out to center. Day with it, leaves it there for Frank. To Sam Annis, runs and guns it up the right side. Chip and chase play behind the goal. Schulte on it first. The Bears pressure him. Puck comes loose to McCormick, who clears it up the middle. Shepherd comes flying out of his net to stop it. And he leaves it behind the goal for Connor McMichael. Under 14 minutes left, first period. The Bears have held the play so far. One shot on this power play in the final minute of it. Dumped in by Snively. DeCord tries to play it. They do a good job keeping it away from him. Now the chase is on in the near corner. Three guys in wide are there. The Bears come up with a puck. Vecchione far wing. Knocked down by Snively. Possession Hershey. McMichael to Borgstrom. Not in his wheelhouse. Back to McMichael. Far side Snively's one-timer. Easy pickings for DeCord. Down to the ice. And made the save. No rebound.
DeCord moving very well. Sees this one all the way. But Fish, we talked about it in the open. The dump and chase, the forecheck sets this opportunity up, and the Bears are getting.
Face off to the left of the goaltender DeCord is Henrik Borgstrom. Here the faceoff circle. I'll see his opposition throw out Cartier in instead. Four in the power play still. Still time for the Bears to make some noise. They win the draw. Right to Snively, shoots. Bad save DeCord. Juicy rebound. Overskated by the Bears. They still have it, though. Snively left wing. Creeps in. His shot deflected by Tennyson up in the air. Clubbed down by Coachella Valley. Out to center. Good start of the power play for Hershey, but no results yet. Still 20 seconds to operate. Snively at center in the 0-0 game. He's flying tonight down the left wing. Ran into Tennyson, who just buried him, and it's cleared. The Cartier shorthanded. Firebirds have 3 shorties in the playoffs. Having none of that was Connor McMichael. But that'll do it for the Bears' power play. They'll go 0-1. As back out of the box is Jesper Froden. His holding minor is over. Klopp here to take the handoff behind his own net. Hershey to center ice in front of benches. It comes to LaPierre, who drives it in on the dump in. DeCord will be able to play this one. Stick handles it around center up the right wing. McElrath with the hit. Both officials are going to call it. And the Bears will be shorthanded on an interference minor on their captain. Take a break and be back. Stay with us. No score. Firebirds to the power play. You're tuned in to the 2023 Calder Cup Finals.
You can't manage what you don't measure. Knowing your risk is an easy first step in preventing cardiovascular disease. Talk to your healthcare provider today. Brought to you by Sheehy Auto Stores during our Sheehy Has Heart sales event to benefit the American Heart Association and to make living a heart-healthy life easier.
How prepared is your family if a hurricane shows up at your doorstep? Or a flood? Or a blizzard? You can't just turn away a natural disaster. That's why it's important to go to ready.gov/plan now. It has the tools and tips you need to make an emergency plan with your family. So if disaster comes knocking,
let's go.
You'll be ready to help keep your family safe.
It's just a pizza.
Yes!
Make a plan today.
Hi, I'm Harry Lennox. Did you know 1 in 6 African-American men will be diagnosed with prostate cancer? Compared to others, African-American men are 76% more likely to get diagnosed and over twice as likely to die from it. I'm joining with the Prostate Cancer Foundation to get the word out. Know your risks, know the numbers. Learn more at pcf.org.
In the Calder Cup playoffs for the Hershey Bears, it has been a wild ride for Todd Nelson's squad. Normally this time of year, we're talking about the 70 rides at Hershey Park. There are 15 coasters. You're riding those. We're riding the wave of the Hershey Bears right now. Looking forward to getting out to Hershey Park soon, but we got hockey to worry about now. They're open 7 days a week. Bears busy next week with 3 at home. Having to defend here on the penalty kill for the first time tonight. Coachella Valley scored on their first opportunity yesterday on a Ty Cartier shot. Shots are 7-1 in favor of Hershey. Dominated this game so far. The McElrath off for interference. Ballenstein on the steal. Short-handed ahead. Broken up. And knocked away from him. Carlson hit by Cartier. That close. Just a game of inches. Nearly a breakaway. Down a man. Firebirds have allowed 2 shorties in the playoffs. Lind with it left corner. They operate it to the right of Hunter Shepard. At the blue line, Cole Lind has it again. Saw him last year with Charlotte. Lind on the left wing. Rolled away from him. The passing not precision right now. Pilon the steal, but could not muster it up with strength to get the puck out. Andrew Podorowski. It runs through him on the right wing. Pass to the left. Lind shot wide to Shepard. To Podorowski, camped on the right side boards. 1-2 straight Calder Cups. Goal line feed to McCormick, who leads the playoffs in goals with 12. At the blue line, Evans. Far wing. Pilon defends to Evans up top. Smooth skating rookie blue line to Podorowski right side. Power play down to 42 seconds. Podorowski the middle. No shots to Shepardet. Evans will take it. Right pad saved by Shepard. He got a good chunk of that one. Center loses stick. The puck held in. Evans to Podorowski. Thinks about unloading. Quick passing play and a great breakup by Iorio. Podorowski behind the net. 25 on the power play. Glued to the tape for the Firebirds. Podorowski all the way around. To the right wing, threw it to the middle, broken up by the Bears and cleared. Good work keeping everything to the outside.
Welcome back, Vinny Iorio, just forcing Podorowski to go all the way around as he tried to dump that one in front.
Power play down to just 5 seconds of the McElrath penalty. Both teams will be 0-1 to start. This has been a good start for the chocolate and white in this one, but they still need to score, looking for their first Calder Cup Finals goal since Game 3, second period, from 2016's 4-game sweep. On the right wing, worked in Hughes to Rafferty. That's a shot well wide. Schultz from the left boards to the goal. Knocked down in front of Shepard. And the Bears with a puck battle the near wing. Firebirds get it back as it's played behind the net. Logan Day trying to sort it out for Hershey. Will clear to center halfway through. Period number 1. Zach Fish, Andrew Kalista here with you. And Albert, our producer, alongside from Palm Desert, California. Game 2 of the Calder Cup Finals. Coachella Valley leads 1-0 after a 5-0 shutout win in Game 1. Hunter Shepard, the Bears goaltender, up the near boards to Ethan Frank. Down the ice it goes. Coachella Valley in their own zone with Matt Tennyson to delay it in his own end. Up the middle of the ice, it's Frank battling for the puck, knocked down and tripped up. Was a Coachella Valley skater in the process. Frank falling over, took a man with him. He wasn't happy. He'll sit. Power play again for the Firebirds when we return. 9:30 left in period number one. No score. You're tuned in to the 2023 Calder Cup Final.
Sometimes
let's ride together.
So I can bring any car into Orsman Chantilly Toyota, and they'll buy it?
That's what they just said on TV.
Doesn't matter what year, make, or model.
No.
And I can get Kelley Blue Book for it?
More. 125%.
And if I buy a new car, I'll get their buyer's edge with $1,500 in bonus extras?
Yes.
I find that very hard to believe.
Ugh.
And don't forget, at Orsman, we'll buy any car. Orsman Chantilly Toyota. Let's ride together.
This right here is the extra-large New York-style pizza from Papa John's. And in order to make a big, tasty, extra-large New York-style pizza like this, you gotta really hand-stretch that fresh, never-frozen dough made from only 6 simple ingredients. Like this. Woo! Look at that! That's what makes a Papa John's extra-large New York-style pizza Papa John's. Better ingredients, better pizza, but you knew that.
Hey, I'm Matt Adams, host of the Fairways of Life show, and you can catch us every week right here on NBC Sports Washington. If it happens in the game of golf, we'll take you inside the ropes.
They're loud here in Palm Desert, their team back to the power play. They're loud at Arugas. Welcome to our fans tuned in at our official watch party at Arugas tonight for game two. Bit of a tough penalty call there on Frank. He got knocked right into Pagansky. I don't know if there's much more he could do.
I mean, it wasn't the hardest of hit, but it wasn't strong enough to stay on the skates. Unfortunately, takes out the Firebirds player. Personally, I don't like it, but the call's made.
Shorthanded for the second consecutive time, despite owning the play so far in this one. It's Coachella Valley with a chance to take that 1-0 lead for the second consecutive game on the power play. But time for the Bears on the kill as it's Gabriel Carlson clearing it all the way down the ice. DeCourt can't handle it. It skates behind the goal. Hammonds with it. We've seen the Bears be able to take advantage of Coachella Valley. A little careless with the puck, and there's another example as Malenstein prods it away. Carlson wants it up the left wing. Looks the middle. He's got Malenstein shorthanded. Down the right wing. Malenstein to the net. He gets knocked down. Snicking his skates there. Wanted a penalty call. Bears bench is up in arms. Patrick Weller giving it to the referees. Can't say I blame him. You want to call a play in the middle of the ice, but not one that impedes a scoring chance. That's a bit curious. Brought in by Coachella Valley. Evans up the left wing. Hits it to Cole Lynn. Fireside half-board. So the blue line, the Firebirds have it set up. To the middle of the ice, the bumper spot. A shotgun block. Knocked the stick out of Iorio's hands. But Hershey is there to clear the length of the pond. Great work by Malenstein, shorthanded. A minute left on the penalty to Frank. 8:25 left, period one. To center ice, it's True. Down the right wing, Alex True behind the goal. Started in the Sharks organization, taken away from him. And once again, cleared by the Bears.
Hershey doing a great job. Firebirds unable to settle anything down here with the extra man.
So far, so good for Hershey on the Bouquet Mulligan to Mail penalty kill. Visit them online at bmdi.com in Cleona and Elizabethtown. Puck cleared by Hershey all the way down. Riley Sutter with it. And it's sent back behind the goal. So the Firebirds have to await something to formulate on the right wing. Down to just 20 seconds left for the Frank penalty. Coachella Valley to center. Picked up with Steen. Now the near wings. Cameron Hughes with the puck. Pulls up along the boards to Rafferty. Top side of the blue line. Schultz from the right circle. A battle in front of the goal. Iorio went down to a knee. Is he and True grappling for a position in front? And True's hard to move. Bears with the steal. Johansson to Frank. Out of the box. And the Bears have killed it off. Here's Frank down the right wing. He gets tripped up. There's going to be a penalty call this time. Frank gets knocked out. His speed causes the issue. Ethan Frank, the fastest guy in the American Hockey League. You know, I was over at Hershey Park in that new Wildcats Revenge roller coaster, 62 miles per hour. Ethan Frank might be the only thing faster than it. You see the stick in the skates. One on four. Four guys around him. He draws the penalty.
That's Ethan Frank right there hitting the first decline of Wildcats Revenge, making a move. And Fish, you said it in game one. Bears have to move their feet. We know Ethan Frank. He does move his feet.
It's like a roller coaster at Hershey Park. Up and down we go. Now it's Bears power play in a 0-0 game. Snively the goal line. Bumper spot. Vecchione fanned on it. Snively's got it again. To the goal line, Morelli. Trying to get to Cord moving here. He's a very aggressive goaltender. Have to get him going laterally. Bears jump on the loose puck. Steal it for a moment. The body to the boards is Morelli. Olofsson can't clear it. Behind the net it goes. Snively to Morelli. Wraps it in front to Cord. The same jam down at the post. It squirts free. The Bears regain possession. McMichael to Borgstrom. The blue line, McMichael. Doesn't shoot it. Far side. One-timer, Snively. Same shot as the first power play. Same result. DeCord's got it.
Chris, you already alluded to it. DeCord moving very, very well. You mentioned how aggressive he is. Well, in game one, Hershey was able to get him out of position multiple times. Couldn't convert. This time, Hershey doing a great job moving the puck. But DeCord in position to make not one, but two saves here on this first power play possession.
Borgstrom on the draw, wins another one. Vecchione looking to the goal for Hershey. 50 points in the regular season for Mike for the first time in his career. Saucer pass McMichael, he'll shoot. Deflected wide into Cord off his body to the far corner. Snively's between the legs, pass doesn't work. It's a Pillerock power play for the Bears. Taken away by the Firebirds. Tennyson will clear a skipper to the goal stick of Shepard. Both teams changing personnel with 6:20 to go in game two of the Calder Cup Finals, period number one. The Firebirds lead the best of seven series, 1-0. We'll head back to the sweetest place on earth next week for game three Tuesday. Day to leave it. The Bears to center. It's Frank with a head of steam down the left wing to Pronis. Back to Frank, losing his stick, Olofsson. Frank leaves it behind the goal. Pilon first on. Olofsson gets the stick back. The Bears work at topside. Day at the center point. Right wing for Annis. Leads for Day. Looks to the goal. Frank's open. They get it to him. He one times it off the post and out. Second goal post of the period for Hershey. Oh, they've come oh so close but haven't been able to beat DeCord, and his best friends are helping him out. First the crossbar earlier. Now the pipe as Ethan Frank nearly had his first of the playoffs. Power play about to expire. There's dumping in Johansson. Soft dump to the far corner, but cleared by Coachella Valley. Hershey couldn't play. It would have been too many skaters. Both teams 0 for 2 on their respective power plays. We remain 0-0. Firebirds with it up the right wing. They center to right. A great save by Shepard, sliding over with his goal stick on Shane Wright. Shot deflected wide to Shepard. The Firebirds with a little momentum after the kill. Another penalty call coming up on Lucas Johansson. And back to the power play go the Firebirds. Man, we've really seen them let them play in the Rochester series, and now they're calling everything. That's the standard. The Bears will have to adjust when we return. 0-0 here in the desert. Game two.
This may look like an action-adventure movie, but it's a Nissan sales event ad. Things are heating up. Good thing this Rogue has the most standard safety features in its class. Our competitors can't say that.
Now get a low $299 per month lease on Rogue.
Hurry. These epic offers won't last forever.
Why do we travel? Because we want to forge a deeper connection with this amazing world. We seek to understand and to be understood. To know that we belong as if we were family. This is the promise of the Salamander Collection. Welcome to our world.
Wizards coverage starts here. Chris and Drew take you inside the game, while the crew and I give you exclusive access to the team. NBC Sports Washington is your home of the Wizards.
Lucas Johansson off for cross-checking now. Special teams galore here in the first. All teams' penalty kills have been good. The Bears to their third penalty kill of period one. Now, if you want to generate offense, you're going to have to be more disciplined for sure. And if this is the way the officials are going to call it, you have to change your game. You want to play physical, but Johansson, a cross check away from the puck, detected by both referees. Once again, like the last one started, a good start for the Bears on the kill. They'll clear the puck all the way down the ice to DeCord, who loves to handle it. Or signing to Arizona State, played the puck well there. He's gotten even better as a pro. Firebird stretching up ice, trying to work in on the rush. It's Gabriel Carlson to get it. He'll clear it down to Coachella Valley territory. Set up by the Firebirds in their own zone. Now rushing along the far wing. It's taken back behind the goal by Evans, who circles the net. Slashed out to McCormick at the point. The Firebirds with it. McCormick to Evans again. On the far wing, it's center and Malenstein up top. 0-0 game. Firebirds power play. Their third of the period with Ponorowski. Leaving to the far side. Cartier had the goal in game one on the main advantage. He's open in front. They go the right wing. Ponorowski's head-hunting slapper misses everything and clears itself down the ice. Not normally going to score from there. There's most penalty kills they've had at a game in the playoffs is four. They've already had three here in the first period. So heavily tested for both teams early in this one. Thrown down the far flank beneath the goal line. It comes free to the boards, or it's taken back to the point. Shrew with it. On the right wing side to Schultz. Beneath the goal line, Jimmy Schultz has it again. Top side to Rafferty. The center point to Schultz along the boards. Defending his nets. Schultz looks to the net front, to the blue line to drive. Rafferty blocked by McMichael. Here he comes shorthanded. Looking for some help. He's tired. Savvy play just to dump it down the ice. How about the shots in this one, Andrew? 15-5, even though Coachella Valley has had their, this is now their third power play.
15 shots in just 11 minutes of actually even strength or extra man time for Hershey. It's pretty impressive. As you said, the discipline has to pick it up so the offense could feast.
Five left of the power play. Rafferty right wing. One-timer deflected wide by Gabriel Carlson. Johansson is back for Hershey. There's penalty kill, passing the test once again. Looking for some offense now. Logan Day leads the charge. 3-on-2 over the blue line. For Johansson to the middle. Three defensemen in there. And it's blocked for Gabriel Carlson. Now the Bears fall back. A new defensive posture, but both teams changing. Puck has just rainbowed into the Bears territory, where Logan Day will wait behind the goal. Up the middle of the ice, he stretches a pass to Henrik Borgstrom. First period, the Bears, as his icing called on Hershey, who scored just five goals in the playoffs in period one. Coming up in our first intermission report, it's a candy clash this series. Coachella Valley is calling for a chocolate boycott. The mistake they made while trying to trash talk the Bears. Plus, we'll chat with Coachella Director of Hockey Ops, Troy Bodie. And Andrew and I will have your first period stats. That's all the first intermission report. How they said, I mentioned a pregame, it's a chocolate boycott. There were chocolate brownies down in the media room today. What's that all about?
As Vince Vaughn would say, erroneous. Erroneous on both counts, Fish.
And Coachella Valley staffers were eating them. I guess, really, you always got a sweet tooth. Puck worked in along the right wing. It is for a good cause, you'll find out from Andrew, going to local food banks here. But they got kind of clowned on by the Bears on social media. And one article online called Coachella Valley's mascot a bozo for ruining some chocolate. Puck dumped in behind the net. Frank with the hit. Tripped up along the near boards is Vecchione. He goes down in some pain. Now the bunt to center ice, overskated by Carson Turinski. Seen him plenty in Lehigh Valley. Former teammate of Mike Vecchione's there. He's our right. Is Vecchione as he heads off to the bench after into the boards. Jones in the center. Hannes will deflect it in. Foot race here. Witko will take it behind the goal. And Protas, under pressure, able to create the puck and knock it loose. Create some separation, I should say. Pass to the blue line. Right side, one-timer, McElrath. Never made it through. There's one thing about Eddie Witko that's his flaw in his game. He's not great under pressure. The Bears created a turnover on him there. Nass's wrist shot tipped in front. Bears going for high tips. It goes wide of the goal. LaPierre on the right wing. He'll dig it free. Looks for someone open. Final minute, five of the period. It's been all Bears in this frame. Far wing LaPierre to McElrath. Skipped Silver's tape. Now the Bears have to pull back to center with less than 60 seconds to play. LaPierre skates away from the pressure. It's Protas with it. And this send it across the ice. LaPierre to Pilon. Onside, cuts it in. Shoots off the crossbar again. What do we have to sacrifice to the hockey gods to get a bounce? The third goalpost to the Hershey Bears here in period one. Well, Joey DeCord has been great, don't get me wrong. My goodness.
Fish, earlier today I made a trek out to Joshua Tree National Park. I thought whatever I did out there and said and looked up to the heavens, that those posts would have benefited the Bears tonight.
Sometimes you got to be lucky to be good. The Bears right now, you hope they haven't run out of luck. They've certainly played well as the puck deflected, heads up, up and out of play into the Bears bench over the head of a backup goaltender, Zach Fucali. They're calling for the usher to come down the stairs. That thing went in the crowd and a fan got nicked, it looks like. As Mike Wagner, Max Finley looks like down there. Bears assistant athletic trainer providing a towel to a fan up there. Nice gesture by him. Face off at center. Well, we talk about finish, and the Bears have come close in so many regards here in period one, but almost doesn't count, as the old song goes. But a lot of encouraging things in their first period of play. This is much more like the Bears team that we've expected and come to know and love. Shot in behind the Bears net. Carlson up the near boards. Gets the puck to Snively. He gets hit hard, and it's launched to center ice. As Garrett Pilon waves at it. Taken back by the Firebirds in their own zone. Final seconds run off the clock. A period dominated by the Bears despite having to kill three penalties. 15-5 the shots. They hit two goalposts, one crossbar, and do everything but score. It's 0-0 after 20 minutes of action. And unfortunately, their shutout streak in the Calder Cup Finals continues after 20 minutes.
They're inches away from putting one in the back of the net, and they did it all these shots and all these quality chances by taking three penalties.
Well, we got a sweet tooth. We'll grab ourselves some chocolate here in between periods, and you can hear more about that fun shenanigans between these two teams coming up. Our intermission report after the break. 0-0, Bears and Firebirds. Stay with us. This is the 2023 Calder Cup Finals.
Driven to go the extra mile. With style that's hard to ignore. The new Highlander goes above and beyond, putting you and your crew in position to upgrade your adventure. Now get 3.49% APR on a new Highlander. Drive with purpose. Arrive in style. Toyota, let's go places.
At AAMCO, we've been fixing cars for almost 60 years. And over that time, a lot sure has changed. Cars have gotten more complex than ever. But the technicians at AAMCO have the expertise to fix anything.
The problem's with your transmission valve body and torque converter. We do this all the time.
So if your check engine light is on, let us take a look. Because we know cars inside and out. AA, MCO.
An easy way to improve your mental well-being and overall heart health is to walk 30 minutes a day. Brought to you by Sheehy Auto Stores during our Sheehy Has Heart sales event to benefit the American Heart Association and to make living a heart-healthy life easier.
The best Capitals coverage starts here, only on NBC Sports Washington, your home of the Washington Capitals. Let's go Caps!
I had 20 years of experience as an HR professional, and I had reached a ceiling, so I enrolled in UMGC. I would not be the person that I am today had it not been for the partnership with UMGC.
My grandfather was a Ukrainian immigrant. He lived in this D.C. row house and owned a tailor shop. My father managed a toy store down the street after he returned from World War II. They both loved the Washington region and taught me to serve our community. That's why my law firm, Greenberg & Betterman, has helped thousands of people in the District, Maryland, and Virginia for over 35 years. We're here to help you, our neighbors and friends.
way. I didn't get it. I did not get it. But a few days later, while shopping at a boutique, that pressure returned, much stronger. It felt like an elephant pressing on my chest. I had a 90% blockage in my main artery and a 75% blockage in the adjacent artery. I was rushed into surgery where I received 2 stents in my arteries. Stents developed through research funded by the American Heart Association. Those stents saved my life. That's why I'm in front of you today, asking you to join me in supporting the American Heart Association by becoming a monthly donor. Call now or go to helpheart.org. For only $19 a month, just 63 cents a day, you can help fund the next medical breakthrough. Get the next person trained in CPR, the next hospital certified in high-quality cardiovascular care. I'm so grateful to the American Heart Association. Their research helped save my life. I can enjoy life with my children, my grandchildren, and my friends. Heart disease is America's number one killer, and your support now can help save your life or the life of someone you love. Give $19 a month with your credit card, and we'll send you this special T-shirt that you can wear to show that you are helping save lives. Please, listen to your heart. The only reason I'm here today is because I did. So please call the number on your screen or go to helpheart.org now. Join me as a monthly donor today and help save even more lives. Thank you.
You can't buy a best friend. You can love them, pet them, care for them, whether they want you to or not. You can take a picture, you can jump, yell, you can fly to the moon, travel the world, or just stay in bed. You can't buy a best friend like that, but you can adopt one. 'Cause we're connected.
Every day,
millions of people are connecting.
And even though we're overcoming obstacles,
watching each other's backs,
and banding together,
We should still make an effort.
To get to know each other
on a deeper level.
Father.
Cosplayer.
Mentor.
Actor.
It's time we take a step forward.
Come together
and discover
how accepting our differences
can make us stronger.
Capital One Arena is the destination for all the best concerts and shows to hit the DMV. From heart-pounding music to show-stopping performances, Capital One Arena has it all. Check out some of the shows coming soon to Capital One Arena. Davido, Alicia Keys, Erykah Badu, Drake. Visit CapitalOneArena.com for more information.
20 minutes in the book of Game 2 of the Calder Cup Finals. Pleased to be joined by Director of Hockey Operations for the Coachella Valley Firebirds, former NHL winger Troy Bodie. Troy, thanks a lot for being here.
Yeah, thanks for having me.
First-year franchise, you're in the Calder Cup Finals, but when the season was about to drop the puck, it didn't seem like that. You guys really didn't have a home to play, kind of road warrior mentality to start the year.
Yeah, you know, it was an interesting season. We started off in Seattle training camp there. 2 months there in a hotel, then 6 weeks on the road once we actually got into our practice facility here. Christmas time before we were actually playing hockey games in the Valley, but, you know, it's been a really good season, and obviously the playoff success has come so far.
This is a great environment. What's it been like having a franchise here in a place that really isn't familiar with hockey and seeing it all come together, the community buying in?
Yeah, the growth of the hockey in the Valley here, you're seeing it exponentially every day, and, you know, the support the community's had for us right from the start's been great, and it's been growing, but you know, to see this place sold out in June is really incredible.
A warm weather environment, this is what executives in every single league want to see, is that not correct?
Absolutely, growing the game in different parts of the world and different parts of the United States here, so we're very proud and very happy with how things are going.
Phenomenal facility here. What went into the design, having the 2 ice sheets in walking distance of both locker rooms?
Yeah, you know, we really pride ourselves on the development aspect of things. We wanted to have our locker room right there so we could practice, we can play in the same rink. You know, we got a nice big gym there as well, and the guys are treated very well. So a lot of thought went into actually development, you know, when we're building this, but also, you know, to put up a good product on the ice and have the fans, you know, get something that they could see.
First trip, you like what you see so far right here in the finals.
Absolutely. Very good.
All right, Troy, thanks a lot. Really appreciate you taking the time. When we come back, Zach Fish returns, and we talk a little bit more about the Hershey Bears and the Coachella Valley Firebirds and what we've seen in the first 20 minutes. You're watching Hershey Bears Hockey right here on Fox 43.
This is not the first all-electric car. That's because no BMW sees the road until it's reached the ultimate standard, our own. A standard that demands every BMW feels exactly like a BMW should. Unparalleled performance and precision handling made possible by electric engineering. But isn't that what you'd expect from the ultimate electric driving machine? Take advantage of financing as low as 2.99% and a $2,000 credit.
The game went back out to Allen. History Twilight.
Before the ball is tipped or a shot is even taken, before the crowd explodes or history's made.
If you're going to bet, have a game plan. Bet legally. Set limits. And keep it fun.
And if gambling becomes a problem,
visit responsibleplay.org to find help.
Even after 40 years serving our area, people still ask, what is a five-star technician? Well, it's simple. They're the best.
When you're talking heating and air conditioning, they're professionally trained and the most knowledgeable in the business. For your plumbing or electrical needs, they can do it all.
For pest control and home performance, trust me, you want a five-star technician at your home.
For more than 40 years, Crop Metcalf, home of the five-star technician.
Crop Metcalf is the one with five stars.
With captivating nature and the thrill of wide open adventure, West Virginia is everything you need for a truly unique escape.
Why do we travel? Because we want to forge a deeper connection with this amazing world. We seek to understand and to be understood. To know that we belong as if we were family. This is the promise of the Salamander Collection. Welcome to our world.
9-2.
Welcome back to Hershey Bears Hockey here on Fox 43. 20 minutes in the books. Just over 4 minutes left here in this first intermission before we drop the puck on the second period. 15-5 right now in shots. We are going to step aside. We are going to wait a little bit until Zach Fish gets back into the booth. It's a very crowded concourse. This Acrisure Arena, as you see the lights go down behind me, it is packed. It is a little bit tough to get around as Fish makes his way back into the booth. A good first 20 minutes here for the Bears. Much of the time spent on the attack, which is what we want to see. Unfortunately, those three penalty kills kind of dampening some of the momentum and the possible scoring chances later on in the period.
Yeah, you got that right for the Hershey Bears. They just got to find a way to connect right now. That's the main difference. You're Todd Nelson, you're saying more of the same. Someone just be the guy to put the puck in the net.
And they've been close. They've hit the post three times. That's exactly what Coach Nelson has been saying. Pick your spots, be smart, take some chances as well with the shots, and put some on net, make Joey Accord make some plays.
Take a breather. This has been our intermission report. We'll be back with the second period of game two. No score, Bears Firebird. This is the 2023 Calder Cup Finals.
Fast, affordable, and aggressive.
As Americans, there's one thing we can all agree on, the promise of our Constitution and the hope that liberty and justice is for all people. But here's the truth. Attacks on our constitutional rights, yours and mine, are greater than they've ever been. The right for all to vote, reproductive rights, the rights of immigrant families, the right to equal justice for Black, Brown, and LGBTQ plus folks. The time to act to protect our rights is now. That's why I'm hoping you'll join me today in supporting the American Civil Liberties Union. It's easy to make a difference. Just call or go online now and become an ACLU Guardian of Liberty. All it takes is just $19 a month, only 63 cents a day. Your monthly support will make you part of the movement to protect the rights of all people, including the fundamental right to vote.
States are passing laws that would suppress the right to vote. We are going backwards.
But the ACLU can't do this important work without the support of people like you. You can help ensure liberty and justice for all and make sure that every vote is counted. So please call the ACLU now or go to myaclu.org and join us. And when you use your credit card, you'll receive this special We the People t-shirt and much more to show you're a part of the movement to protect the rights guaranteed to all of us by the U.S. Constitution.
We protect everyone's rights, the freedom of religion, the freedom of expression, racial justice, LGBTQ rights, the rights of the disabled. We are here for everyone.
It is more important than ever to take a stand. So please join us today, because We the People means all the people, including you. So call now or go online to myaclu.org to become a guardian of liberty.
This may look like an action-adventure movie, but it's a Nissan sales event ad. Things are heating up. Good thing this Rogue has the most standard safety features in its class. Our competitors can't say that.
Now get a low $299 per month lease on Rogue.
Hurry. These epic offers won't last forever.
The second period of Hershey Bears hockey on Fox 43 is presented by Members First Federal Credit Union.
Hershey Bears hockey, the Calder Cup Finals with Andrew Kalista. I'm Zach Fish. Beautiful sights here in Palm Desert nearby. You guys got a chance to explore a little bit today.
Joshua Tree National Park. I'd recommend it to anybody. Nice, easy 45-minute drive out there to the entrance. Clears the mind, clears the soul.
A lot of Bears fans in attendance here, more so than yesterday. Or Thursday, beg your pardon. Talk about some of them in a bit. Cheering on the chocolate and white. They outshot the Firebirds 15-5 of the first. Three goalposts. See if they can be rewarded in period number two. DeCord way out to play it. Up the near boards. A little roller to center ice. Ty Cartier with it. Had a heck of a rookie season. 28 goals, 57 points. The AHL's rookie of the year. Frank had more goals than him. He had more assists and earned the nod over Ethan. That giveaway by Carlson. Wrist shot blocked by McElrath. Pettman has it again. Fireside one-timer. Pulled off the tape wide of the goal. And a very uncharacteristic turnover by Gabriel Carlson there. Among the Bears' best defensively. Ian McElrath stalwarts on the back end. A shot in behind the Bears. Nat Shepard will play into the near corner boards. It's McElrath with it. Slows the tempo and leaves it beneath the goal line. Long changes in the second period. Center out there on the right side will deflect it in and make a beeline to the bench. It's a DeCord to play it and shuffles it up the left wing. Max McCormick with it. Shoots it in back behind the goal. Veteran of 450-plus American League games. Their leader. Puck cleared all the way down to the Coachella Valley end. 0-0 just underway in period number two. Borgstrom with it. Will drop it on back. The far side, Johansson nearly turned it over, but he gets it right back and scoots on ahead. Neutralized offensively, slicing through the defense. Knocked down. Couldn't finish the play as Evans sent him to the ice. But now it's Evans that's pasted in the boards by Mike Vecchione. We knew this series was going to be physical and has been as advertised in that regard. Whistle and a hand pass called. Radio side, let's take a quick pause, 10 seconds for station identification. Just after 11 o'clock back in Chocolate Town, those tuned in on the Highmark Bears Radio. face off right in front of the Hershey Bears bench as Todd Nelson marches on, going for his fourth Calder Cup. Far side, the Bears steal it behind the net. Snively will wrap it free, leads for Day, who shoots into court. Got it with the glove. And there was a lot of traffic in front. And Logan Day trying to wire home the tally. And Day denied, looking for his fourth of the playoffs.
Day with a quick wrister. He's going to have this opportunity right here from Joe Snively. You see the core just able to see that through the traffic. Didn't even flinch.
Well, the court's dialed. Absolutely. That and the goalpost, the only reason the Bears aren't up by a couple here, but face off to the left of DeCord. Underneath the goal line, it's Pilon after it. Up the far side. To center ice, Day will smash it in behind the net. Far wing, pops loose in front, McMichael spinning backhander, blocked away by Olsson to the near boards. Froden to center. Page the hit attempt. Firebirds three wide over the blue line. Skied in offensively. Hughes' attempt to the net. Garrett Pilon, red left like a good book, is able to chuck it away. Hughes to the goal line. Pilon again in perfect defensive posture. The Bears to center. Ness will lead the charge over the blue line right wing. Connor McMichael to the middle off the stick of Snively. Here we go the other one. Pacella Valley to center. Pilon back to help out again, but a two-on-one. McElrath steps up and breaks up the Froden pass. And the Bears breathe a sigh of relief.
Two times in a row, Garrett Pilon getting an initial stop on defense right there and allowing Dylan McElrath some time to recover and deflect that pass.
Nearly 3 minutes off the clock in period number two. Back behind the goal. The Bears with it. Not a lot of hockey left to be played in the hockey world. NHL will finish later than everybody. Annis to tip it in. LaPierre behind the net with one-handed free. Winko hit by the Bears along the boards. It's Prodis' former teammate drawing the puck loose to the far corner. And all the way down the ice it goes where the Bears chase back after it. And Hershey behind the goal line. It's Iorio with it for the far wing. Healthy hit, took it to make the play. To center, it's LaPierre. He'll handle it down the right wing. Looks for some help. LaPierre with his head up. Looked to thread the needle. His pass was blocked by Winko. And cleared to center ice. Stolen away. A break ahead. Terinsky's got a breakaway in on Shepherd. The backhand rolled off his tape. We might have a penalty shot. We'll see here. The whistle and the point to center ice. It's a penalty shot. A penalty shot for Carson Terinsky of Coachella Valley. And Hunter Shepherd going to be called upon. The last time we've seen a penalty shot against the Bears in the playoffs, 2016. Jake Gensel was stopped by Justin Peters. Carson Terinsky, Hunter Shepherd, four goals in the playoffs for the St. Alberta native. Terinsky shoots left. Shepherd stands guard. Fans on their feet to keep this a 0-0 game. Bears puck stopper needs one here. Terinsky starts in over the blue line. Between the circles, shoots, and Shepherd with the save with the blocker and a fist pump as he pumps up the bench. This game remains 0-0. The most exciting play in sports, the penalty shot. And Carson Terinsky shut down by Shepherd.
I don't care what Terinsky's doing on that. All I'm thinking about is what Mike Vecchione said. Hunter Shepherd is a killer, and when he looks through you, he will kill you with his glare, and that is exactly what Shepherd does right there, stepping up huge between the pipes, and that's why we love him in Shakertown.
First penalty shot since that run in 2016 against. We've seen one for the Bears in the playoffs. Sam Annis was denied in the postseason. Off the whistle, a faceoff, and a quick penalty call. Right off the draw, I think another one coming up here on the Bears. Dylan McElrath going to go, and they've called these little slashes all playoff long. Here's a look at it.
Here's the slash. I go back to Beck Malinson in the first period, going to the net, gets taken down, and no call on that.
Just want consistency. Where is it round to round? I mean, we haven't seen this many penalties called all playoffs. We got 16-12 left of the period. The Bears got to do a better job with discipline, but the consistency is just not there. up the near wing. Penalty kill called upon for the fourth time. Ties the most they've been worked in the playoffs. Far side. Puck to the boards, to the blue line, Evans. He'll walk in, left circle, wins drive, blocked by Carlson. Bears are going to have to grind this one out, no doubt. Puck deflected up and out of play. That's not a minor penalty. Sutter shot it off a stick and into the crowd. And yeah, we have a couple friends from various AHL staffs in California here. I'm not going to name the team, but just got a text from two different ones that said the refs need to put the whistles away. So even those without a rooting interest would agree. But you know what? Crying about officiating is going to get you nowhere. You got to kill this off and start putting some pucks in the net. It's a faceoff win by the Bears, and it's Iorio gunning it down the ice. Wide of DeCore. So a couple turning points in this game for sure. You could look at the goalposts of the first period. You could look at the penalty shot here. Special teams is going to be key for both squads. Center ice, it's Carlson with it. Shooting it down the ice. Well done by the Hershey defender. New rotation of penalty killers. Patrick Weller, Bears assistant coach, been with the club since 2018. Throws some new guys over the boards. He won a Calder Cup with Hershey as a player. 2010, the Firebirds are offside. Andrew, good to see some Bears fans here. I ran into Rob in between periods of the concourse. You talked to him earlier, put a great picture out on social media. A Marine stationed in San Diego, drove a couple hours. He's from back in the Hershey area. Listens to all the games on the radio, hearing his Bears gear, cheering the team on. Just awesome.
Well, Fish, I'll tell you, every single Bears fan that I run into, they just want to come over and meet you.
Oh, I don't know about that.
They love you.
Puck worked in on the near wing shot. Coachella Valley on the power play. 50 seconds on the man advantage. McElrath's second penalty of the game. Far side corner. Firebirds with it. Fans trying to start a wave again while their team's on a power play. They center and shoot. Score. And in over a sprawled Shepherd. The fourth power play hits Bader. It's 1-0 Firebirds. A strike with 14:52 left in the second. They grab the lead in game two.
Eighth shot on net. Fourth time on the extra man. A penalty shot. Finally one. Squirts free here. Held in. Backside top shelf. Tough save for Shepard.
And Groden kind of fanned on it. Look at Shepard. He's there, but the puck almost knuckles up and over his glove. Expecting the fastball. He got a knuckler instead. And the eighth shot of the game, Coachella Valley leads 1-0 in the playoffs when they score first. Coachella Valley owns a record of 10-2. So the Bears have done a lot right. They need some puck luck on their side. Back to work. Vecchione the net front. Tipped on goal. DeCorn. Left the rebound, but clear into the line. McElrath will keep it in, but the Firebirds take it in their own end. Carlson on the far wing. Puck down, and Coachella Valley with it. And Witko to center, deflected behind the Bears' net. Shepherd with it, up the far wing, and to center it goes. Henrik Borgstrom with it. At the red line, turned it over. Vecchione gets it back, and the Bears dump it in. And head for a line change. So Coachella Valley draws first blood. You knew the dam was going to break eventually on the power play. Ness behind the goal. Thought it was icing. There was no call made. He has to play it hurriedly to center. Elon with it on the near wing. He's leveled hard. Riker Evans knew about the offense. He's pretty physical as well. Impressive on the back end for the Firebirds. The center ice. Evans with it again. Sidestep Snively, charging down the left wing. Shot saved by Shepherd off the right shoulder. Thrown in front, comes loose to Hughes. He scores! 2-0 Coachella Valley with 13:38 left in the second. They've got a pair in a row.
Off the rebound, Shep protecting the near side post. Somehow squirts free. Snively can't find Hughes. Leaves them wide open right in the slot.
Actually, Austin Pagansky, I think they got that second one. Hughes was in front. 14-19. It doesn't matter. It's 2-0. Coachella Valley. Sam Annis with it to the net front. Knocked down and taken away and cleared up the far wing out to center. Well, the Bears, you knew, so they're going to draw a penalty here. They're going to get a power play, it looks like. Holding the call. Believe it's on Coachella Valley. 13-16 to go. Power play would be big for the Bears. We'll see what the call is when we return. Two in a row for the Firebirds. They have the lead. This is the 2023 Calder Cup Finals.
Hey, Bears fan, Fox 43 Sports.
The GMC Sierra with hands-free driving. Yeah, it rocks. Or did 0.9% APR plus over 1,200 trade assistance and no monthly payments for 90 days on Sierra 5.3-liter V8 light-duty models.
5-Hour Energy. Think of it as 5-second coffee for when you wake up too late to make it. Or you don't have time to wait in line for it. Or you're just too busy for a coffee break. 5-Hour Energy. The 5-second coffee.
Don't freak out, but you can get 50% off all menu price Domino's pizzas when you order online right now.
Right now?
Right now.
Right now?
Right now?
Right now.
50% off, honey, right now!
Now through the end of the week, get 50% off all menu price pizzas when you order online at Domino's.
NBC Sports Washington is your home in the District of Champions.
Power play for Hershey, and they need one here. The Firebirds get two in a row. Broden's fourth at 5:08. Paginski's first, 6:22 from Wright Evans. Bears got caught running around. Now to the man advantage, though. Max McCormick is off for holding. Hershey's power play for the third try. Trying to make this a 2-1 game and get back in it. Done everything but score. They got to beat the cord here. Get some confidence. McMichael at the point, right side to Snively. Pass misses, and all the way down the ice it goes. Foot race is on, and Hayden knocks it behind the net of Connor McMichael. Pinned into the boards. Hayden taken away by Borgstrom. Five forwards out for Hershey. They rush to center. Morelli to the right, Vecchione. Passing his feet, not clean. He'll pull up along the boards, needs help. To Morelli, right goal line. Walks to the net himself, shoots short side, a stop by Decor. The puck pinballs around behind the net. Smashed by Schultz, down the ice. Two nothing Firebirds, power play for 1:15 for Hershey. And a whistle here. And the net, is off behind Decor, and Decor has his mask off as well. Morelli, I think, hit him in the mask with that short side try.
Not a great initial start here to the Bears power play with that puck being sent out of the zone. See if they could gather their composure here, settle down. Need to get one.
Looking at the last goal, I don't know what Snively was doing there. Man just walked right around him. I don't think he saw that the puck went to Paginski, turned the wrong way. It looks worse on video than probably it was on the ice for Joe, but Paginski sidestepped him, and Snively was kind of standing there, feet stuck in the mud. But all that can be changed quickly with a strike on the power play. Need someone in white to come up with a game-breaking moment. Annis on the right wing will deflect it in. Decor is there to play it. Down the ice it goes. Bears can't get discouraged. It's tough not to be it when you hit three posts, have 15 shots of the first period, get a penalty shot saved from your goaltender, and then suddenly, bang, bang, you're down 2-0. Protas along the left wing. He'll play it to Pilon. In his feet, far side. Logan Day with the puck. Dust it off along the left wing. Frank looks to the goal. To the point, Day. Far side. It's Frank with it again. To the middle, Pilon walks in the backhander. Stopped by Decord. Rebound swung out. Annis' backhander rolls wide. Frank to recollect. Sends it behind the net. 20 on the power play. Bears down by two. They need one here. Annis takes it to the right side. Corner boards. To the point, Day. To Sam Annis again. Goal line feed. Bumper spot. Pilon. Shot deflected wide. Set up they wanted. Just not finished. Panis to the net front, looking there, tipped on goal, DeCord the save, Protas the rebound, DeCord has got it again. And the fans here in Palm Desert love their netminder for that one.
If it's not Joey DeCord, it's the post. Quality biscuit chance right there, Protas on the redirect, and DeCord smothering up.
The fans applauding their goaltender. You see DeCord, what he's done tonight and what he's done in the playoffs. 3 seconds left for the McCormick Minor. The Bears defense will have to be aware of him coming out of the penalty box if they lose the draw. Sutter on the tie-up, right to LaPierre, shoots, and DeCord's got it again. He's like a vacuum right now. Everything is sticking to Joey DeCord. A Boston, Massachusetts native, father a goaltender, played in the Swiss. Right on goal, and DeCord mops it up. Sutter on the draw again. We're back to 5-on-5. Sutter, Malenstein, and LaPierre count there for Hershey. 0-for-3 on the man advantage. Podorowski in over the blue line. On the left wing to the middle, McCormick dispossessed. Podorowski with the puck once more. Cut down by the Bears, and the look to break to center. Sutter taking a stroll behind his own net. Still half a hockey game left. A similar fate to what the Bears had in game one. And the fact that they're down 2-0 here in the middle stands in that. And yet to score a goal in the Calder Cup Finals. More so, yet to beat Joey DeCord, who's looking like a force that the Bears are not going to be able to break through. Iorio to center. Frank with it along the right wing. Bounced off the hit, fell down, got him. Staple in the boards by Schultz. Puck taken away. Malenstein, a heavy hit, and a penalty call coming up on Hershey. And the complete standard that was in the round against Rochester has been thrown out by these officials. Another penalty call coming up on the Bears. 10:15 left here in the second. Dylan McElrath apparently can't play the game of hockey. Interference, mine. Let's see if we get a look at it. This isn't the penalty here. This is Frank just getting hit. This is a hit by Malenstein. There's my man. McElrath took his man out. I mean, they've let some stuff like that go in the playoffs, but Dylan's got to be disciplined. It's his third penalty. Yeah, the officials are calling it. You don't like it, but you got to know that that's going to get called right now.
Dangerous, dangerous territory right now for Hershey.
Need this penalty kill to remain down by two. McElrath to sit. There's Captain, watch the line. He does it very well, but tonight the officials have had his number and called it for a third time for the Miners. Puck on net, Shep with a save, the rebound bouncing around, and it's Malenstein to take it to center, rumbling shorthanded. Now the near wing, he'll move his feet, bounces off the hit of Schultz. Malenstein kills the clock a little bit and brings it out to center. Drew with it. Over the blue line, the Firebirds in along the near wing. Hughes with the puck. Elon there. Hughes gets around him. Broden fires side. Hughes in the left circle. Is open. The Bears keep him wide to the left. The Firebirds work the right wing. For the blue line, Rafferty doesn't shoot it. They leave it to Froden. The goal scorer, he got the party started. Firebirds fans want a shot. There's no lane. The Bears doing a good job. Coachella Valley will skate it back to the far side half boards up top near the blue line. Interchange to the right side. Hughes to the blue line. Left wing throwed it in front. Tip wide of the goal by Drew. Got there in good stick position on Iorio. Well, the shot deflected wide. Bears look to clear it in the feet of Pilon. Good work by Garrett. Playing a great two-way game tonight. He gets down the ice.
Great work. Desperate for the clear right there with the long change. Get fresh penalty killers on the ice.
Cord got it just in front of the no-touch area there. Center ice. Firebirds over the blue line. Malenstein stabs at it. Nest to break up. Good kill by the Bears so far. 30 seconds left on it. And the wave starting of the party-like atmosphere here at Coachella Valley. 2-0 Firebirds. Up the gut to center ice. Stick handled in along the left wing. Johansson trying to knock it loose. comes free to Karchin. Open in front was McCormick. And the right circle, the pass off the mark, and Evans has it go over his tape to center. Critical kill for the Bears. 5 penalty kills in this game, the most they've had in the playoffs. Puck is cleared all the way down, and icing is waved off. Fireman's play to the middle, Evans. Bears scrambling, Evans, and deflects up and in. I said it earlier, sometimes you gotta be lucky to be good. That's as weird of a goal as you're gonna see. It's Evans' fourth of the playoffs. I think the Bears thought there was going to be icing on this play. And they got caught watching the puck.
As it leaks out off the board and the deflection as it butterflies into the net. Fish, I think you're right. McElrath out of the box instead of coming back into the zone, headed right for the bench for a change. Two things come together for something very, very bad for the Bears.
In behind the Coachella Valley net. 3-0 Coachella Valley. And not that it's Hunter Shepard's fault, but I have to wonder if Todd Nielsen thought maybe to go to Zach Fucali to try to change things up here. He thought about it. He told the media post-game in the third period of game number one. Elects to keep Shepard in. I mean, he made the penalty shot save, a kind of a knuckler on the power play, and that one you can't fault him for. And a point-blank opportunity where the Bears, a couple times, have been caught puck-watching in this second period. And Coachella Valley just too skilly. 3 goals on 13 shots. I mean, we talked about how opportunistic they are, and that certainly has come to fruition. Day trying to provide the shot in the arm. He's got on the right wing. He shoots wide of the goal. Trying to beat the cord blocker side. This point, if I... McElrath behind the goal will take the puck after Carlson made a savvy defensive play to strike the Bears to center. Pilon on the chip-in. Malenstein trying to change the register. Digs the puck free along the left boards. Hits it to Riley Sutter. One hands it behind the net. Morelli up to the point. McElrath's wrist shot. Knocked down in front. Wide open. Podorowski's got a breakaway to make it 4-0. He's in. He fakes. Shepard the save. Where is it? Underneath him to the corner. And Hunter Shepard... And it keeps it 3-0 with a save on Podorowski, who tried to cut back. Morelli over the blue line, dancing down the right wing. 3-0 Firebirds. The point, Dane's drive deflected in front, center after it. And again, Coachella Valley with an answer to knock it away from the net front. Sutter with a heavy hit. Now the puck back to the Bears' defensive zone. Under 5 left. Here in period number 2, Protas is in. DeCourt is out with a poke check. Comes free and battered around behind the goal. Firebirds can't clear it. Day on the keep it. Penalty on the Bears coming up. Mason Morelli for cross-checking. And a shot after the whistle is going to draw a crowd from Hershey. And frustration setting in for the Bears. 4:35 left. The Firebirds have taken this game over, and they're going to the power play again. Morelli to sit back after this. This is the 2023 Calder Cup Finals.
Elite Coach.
We love living and working in and around the nation's capital, a place that millions of people visit each year. But that means a lot of traffic, a lot of crashes, and unfortunately, a lot of injured people. That's why when someone breaks the safety rules and causes harm, we hold them accountable. We've been a part of this community for over 30 years. It's our home, and we want it safe. When injuries change your life, call the lawyers that care. Call Chase and Boscola, 1-800-728-5898.
Let's ride together.
So I can bring any car to Oarsman Alexandria Kia, and they'll buy it?
That's what they just said on TV.
Doesn't matter what year, make, or model.
No.
And I can get Kelley Blue Book for it?
More. 125%.
And if I buy a new car, I'll get their buyer's edge with $1,500 in bonus extras?
Yes.
I find that very hard to believe.
Ugh.
And don't forget, at Oarsman, we'll buy your car. Oarsman Alexandria Kia. Let's ride together.
Kill Mesa Morelli, a cross check in the offensive zone of the net front. Three goal posts for the Bears in the first period. They could have been up 3-0. Firebirds have converted three times here in the second. And another try on the power play to really blow this thing open. 3 in a row in Chocolate Town, USA coming up. Well, you wanted to get one here. And that task is pretty daunting right now. Not impossible, but a fourth goal here would make it a climb that was treacherous, if not already impossible. Firebirds wheeling around behind the goal. They've just scored on the power play. Far wing boards behind the net. McElrath looks to come up with it. Knocked free to the point. Evans far shot. Ryker Evans with it to Cole Lynn. Thinks about shooting, instead goes to the goal line. McCormick behind the net. Former Binghamton Senator, the only other time he scored 20 goals was there. Surpassed that this year. Feeds on the right wing. Shepard standing up a shot. It deflects wide and ricochets back to the point. It's Evans from the center point with the puck. Lynn to the middle. One-timer. Cartier, Shepard the save. And McElrath will clear. McCormick out. Sutter throws a big hit. The officials elect not to call that. I think they're going to call both guys, actually, after the fact. McElrath falling all over himself. And now it looks like there is going to be a penalty on the Bears.
Just saw the clear out by Riley Sutter in front.
They're going to call both guys. Todd Nelson looks as puzzled as we are just with how this game is going. Okay, the Bears did everything right early except finish. We've seen the standard, the rule book kind of completely thrown out for what it's been in the playoffs. And then three go in, including a flutter that just seems like Coachella Valley has the game right now where they want it. Doesn't matter about the calls. I mean, it does. We're not saying that, but you got to put the puck in the net in your opportunities. The Bears have not been able to do that. You talk about the officiating all you want, but that the players will tell you that. But frustration certainly mounting. Coincidental penalties, center in the box for Hershey. McCormick for Coachella Valley. Left side, Broden slap pass deflected wide. True is just absolutely hard to move at the net front. Puck free of the near boards, cleared by Hershey all the way down. It was actually Lynn, beg your pardon, that goes for roughing as they just updated the score sheet. Firebirds with it to center, under three left here in the second period. As unfortunately for her, she's seen this game go sideways. Pass in the corner, trying to dig the puck loose. Tied up underneath the Coachella Valley player. Morelli's back. The Bears have killed this one off. And Mason Morelli with it to center. Love just one before the end of the period. Morelli down the left wing to the net. Decord to save the rebound off his glove. And the Firebirds come up with it and rush to center. Off the air, down behind the play. Slow to get up. Pepin's in. Zips it by to Shepard. Froden with it. Will backhand it off the glove of McElrath and take it away. Coachella Valley, the blue line, broken up by Borgstrom. And McElrath to slow it at center. Frank unable to work it in. Feels like an eternity ago, Andrew, that Turinski was shut down by Shepard on the penalty shot at 3:46.
For all the momentum that Hershey thought they had.
Another whistle, another penalty. It's the Bears here that look like they're going to the power play, but this is in a game dominated by the Firebirds, and the guys in stripes have had plenty to put their arms up for. Take a breather and be back. This is Hershey Bears hockey.
Hey, I'm Matt Adams, host of the Fairways of Life show, and you can catch us every week right here on NBC Sports Washington. If it happens in the game of golf, we'll take you inside the ropes.
Every 2 minutes, a woman in the U.S. is diagnosed with breast cancer. And that's why when others look away, we lean in. We're fighting alongside patients because we know one moment can change everything. With your help, more moments of hope are possible. Join our fight. Save lives.
At Social Security, we are always thinking of ways to save you time and make things easier. That's why we created My Social Security. A My Social Security account allows you to access your earnings history and benefits information, request a replacement Social Security card, get a proof of income letter, estimate and apply for benefits, and more. Save time. Go online. Open a My Social Security account at ssa.gov/myaccount. Social Security. Securing today and tomorrow.
Produced at U.S. taxpayer expense.
I don't know why I thought it would be the Bears that would be going to the power play. The way this one is gone, Dylan McElrath has taken a fourth minor penalty, and he was just absolutely incensed going to the box. He's going for tripping.
And what I don't understand is some of the officials on the ice we've already seen. So when you're saying the rule book's been thrown out and the standard hasn't been kept, it's completely different than what we have seen.
Yeah, that's it.
From members of the same group.
It's just... We've seen it called and let the players decide it. Things egregious. Slashes on the hands have been at the forefront of what they've been calling. Oh, great move. Hughes walks in and scores. Wow, what a goal on the power play. That is Cameron Hughes for sure. That's gorgeous. Coachella Valley's got four in the second. And a 4-0 lead here in game two.
Pretty slip move coming right in on the blue line. From a name Bears fans know very well, Cam Hughes.
What a move. Watch this move. Turning Hershey's defense inside out. Five on four. He just slashed the D up like a knife right there. Wow. Sometimes you got to tip your cap. That's a scenario. The scenario. Cameron Hughes, what a goal. Coachella Valley to center. Pettman with the puck. Well, we knew the Firebirds were good. I don't know if we knew they were this good. And credit to Dan Bilesman's squad. Goaltender Joey Decord gets the lone assist on the goal. Another penalty call coming up. On the Bears. 45 seconds left in the second period. I don't know what to say, folks. I'm going to be honest with you. The Bears don't have answers for the Firebirds. Coachella Valley, I believe this is their 8th power play now that they're about to go to.
It's speechless.
Face off to the right of Shepherd. Well, the Firebirds only have one on the power play previous to that rush by Hughes. And I mean, that's a gorgeous goal, power play or not. Sutter just pitchforks True and knocks him down. If I'm Todd Nelson, I think you got to go to Zach Fucale in the third period. And again, it's no disrespect to Hunter Shepherd. I think you got to get him out of there and let him get ready for game three. And I think you got to give the Bears some sort of change of momentum to try to build around that. Their starting goaltender has been great and really hasn't had a shot on a lot of these tonight. He hasn't had any goal support either. You got to give him a break and get ready to go back to Hershey and try to do it on your home ice. Johansson with a shot block attempt into the glove of Shepherd, and he makes the save. 22 seconds left in the period. Well, stay with us for our intermission report. I'll tell you more about it in a moment. Joined by Hockey Hall of Famer Grant Fuhr, and I asked him how to beat Joey DeCord earlier today. We're going to talk about that again, as the Bears need it here. Another period without a goal against the goaltender. Unfortunately, surrendered four. Ponorowski with it on the right wing. Feeds the near wing to Lynn. At the point, Emmons. A shot. Shepherd the save to the corner in front. Cartier shoots. Blocked by Johansson. And get us to the locker room to regroup. Four for the Firebirds in the second. A penalty fest. Cody Beach and Brandon Schrader have called everything. The Bears can't find the back of the net. And the Firebirds just continue to show their firepower. 4-0 Coachella Valley through five periods in the Calder Cup Finals. They've outscored Hershey 9-0. Second intermission report. Coco will join us. Not the mascot. We're talking NHL Hockey Hall of Famer and Stanley Cup champion Grant Fuhr. He'll join me. He's the color analyst for the Firebirds. Plus John Walton. See if he has any answers. He'll join us, the voice of the Caps. Andrew and I have your second period stats. That's all in the second intermission report. 4-0 Firebirds will step aside. This is the 2023 Calder Cup Finals.
Freisinger Buick.
An easy way to lower your risk of heart disease is to eat smart and to move more. Brought to you by Sheehy Auto Stores during our Sheehy Has Heart sales event to benefit the American Heart Association and to make living a heart-healthy life easier.
5-Hour Energy wants to charge up your summer. Just purchase any 5-Hour Energy product, then enter for a chance to win an EcoCharge electric ATV. Just go to 5hecharge.com for details. 5-Hour Energy. Charge it up.
Marlowe Furniture's Memorial Day Savings Event is held over. Great styles, designer looks. Save 50% off. Plus, take an extra 15% off Marlowe's huge selection of fine quality furniture. Plus, your choice of free delivery or 5-year special interest financing. Memorial Day deals. Beautiful sofas, $6.99. Amazing dining sets, $8.99. Stylish queen bed, $4.99. Marlowe's Memorial Day sale is held over. Save 50% off. Plus, an extra 15% off. Plus, free delivery or 5-year special interest financing. Marlowe Furniture, with the area's largest showrooms under one roof since 1955.
Dominating the rugged terrain with unstoppable power and agility, the Toyota Tacoma is ready to take on anything. Outfitted with the latest technology and the reliability only Toyota is known for. Now get 3.99% APR on a Tacoma. Unmatched, unstoppable. Toyota, let's go places.
Hello, innovation. Goodbye, injuries. Hello, science. Goodbye, seizures. Hello, tiny incisions. Goodbye, lengthy recoveries. At Children's National Hospital, we're making breakthroughs daily so we can say hello to a healthier future for kids.
At AAMCO, we've been fixing cars for almost 60 years. And over that time, a lot sure has changed. Cars have gotten more complex than ever. But the technicians at AAMCO have the expertise to fix anything.
The problem's with your transmission valve body and torque converter. We do this all the time.
So if your check engine light is on, let us take a look. Because we know cars inside and out. Double A, MCO.
Welcome back to Hershey Bears Hockey, our second intermission report here in Coachella Valley. And pleased to be joined. We've upgraded our talent here as far as hockey knowledge. Grant Fuhr, five-time Stanley Cup champion, Hockey Hall of Famer, work on the Coachella Valley broadcast. Thanks for joining us. Stepping in for Andrew here in intermissions. It's great to have you. They built something pretty special here in the desert. Obviously, we're biased as a Hershey Bears fan base and broadcast, but this is pretty awesome here. What has it been like for you as a longtime native of this area and resident of this area to really get to enjoy now the hockey side of it?
You know what? When I first moved down here, it was more for the weather and enjoy a little bit of golf and such. And always thought it'd be a perfect place if we could add arena, a little bit of hockey. And I got my wish. It just took 50 years, but we've got some hockey here now, and good hockey, and a great building to be a part of. It's been exciting.
It's been an exciting run for the Firebirds, Western Conference champions, with a 1-0 lead. Injuries here coming into game number two. When you look at this team, you've had a chance to all year. They started on the road, but they've just been hot as a pistol, really down the stretch. Makes them such a good club, top to bottom.
Well, I think part of the reason they've been here is they started on the road. I think we played our first 22 games on the road, which is usually unheard of. But at the same time, the building wasn't quite ready yet. They got a chance to bond, so it's a really close-knit team. That the guys got a real commitment to playing for each other.
When you look at this Coachella Valley team, they got a great goaltender in Joey DeCord, and the Bears are going to have a tough time trying to beat him, as we saw in game one with the shutout. As a former goaltender yourself, he loves to handle the puck, and he's steady back there. What have you liked from him, and what the Bears got to do to beat him?
You know what I really like about Joey? He's pretty relaxed. I mean, I think you'll see that. He's pretty calm with the puck. And he's like having that extra defenseman out there. He loves to handle a puck. And you look at the game the other night where the Bears, the Bears dumped it in. Joey's out there handling a puck. It kind of breaks up the forecheck a little bit. It seems to adapt to it after a little while. But at the same time, it forces the team to think a little bit differently.
It's been the bread and butter there, forecheck so far in this run. Look, you were in Hershey last for three ice. I know that's coming there again, and you'll be doing three ice in other cities this time around. But you played just a little bit in the American Hockey League. But Gordie Howe said it. Everybody kind of knows Hershey. What do you know about Hershey coming in as the newest team takes on the old team?
You know what? I love Hershey. I mean, that's the one thing is I've been lucky. The two times I've been there, I've stayed at the Hershey Hotel, so it's hard to beat that. But now, last year we came in for three ice, plus I come in for the Mid-Penn Bank City Golf Tournament every year, so... you always enjoy coming back, and it's always a lot of fun.
Sweetest place on earth, and here in the desert, good golf there, good golf, Chocolate Town, USA. I know you're still keeping your game sharp, but Grant, this is great. Appreciate you doing this. Best of luck to the Firebirds, and you know what? Hopefully we can make this an annual thing, come out here to the desert.
I would love that. I think it'd be a great thing, and hopefully we get to see a few more games out here.
Grant Fuhr, commentator for the Coachella Valley Firebirds and NHL Hall of Famer. We'll take a breather. More to come. You're tuned in to the Calder Cup Finals on Fox 43.2.
Turn down the outside noise with SoundShield. This is more than a window. It's peace and quiet. Hear the difference with Thompson Creek's exclusive SoundShield windows, filtering out 35% more noise than our standard double-pane windows. And call right now to save 40%. Buy one, get one 40% off all SoundShield windows. Hear the difference with SoundShield. Call 855-57-CREEK.
With captivating nature and the thrill of wide open adventure, West Virginia is everything you need for a truly unique escape.
With Jiffy Lube Multicare, it's our job to keep you moving. With a full range of services from oil changes and tires to brakes, batteries, and more, we've got what your car needs right when you need it. So you're ready for whatever's next. Putting you in the driver's seat of car care, that's a job for Jiffy. At Jiffy Lube, it's our job to make car care make sense with personalized service reviews that swap the car talk for straight talk, so you know what your car is telling you and what to do about it. Putting you in the driver's seat of car care, that's a job for Jiffy.
Hi, I'm Dak Shepard, and I'm the kind of guy that likes to do things myself, like change my own light bulbs. I do my own laundry. I even make my own jam. So when my doctor told me he needed to check my prostate, I said, I'll do it myself. Can I get the jam back? Don't DIY your health. Early screening by a doctor can save your life. To learn more, go to pcf.org.
COVID-19 has left many seniors alone and needing our help. My dad worked closely with Meals on Wheels for over 25 years because he knows the vital lifeline it provides.
Dad, tell me when you first got an inkling about Meals on Wheels.
My neighbors and friends and so on realized there was a need. I think it's meaningful to be giving and helpful.
It created this sense of belonging.
Give today at mealsonwheelsamerica.org/seniorsneedyou.
Welcome back to Hershey Bears Hockey here on Fox 43, joined now by former voice of the Bears and current voice of the Capitals, John Walton. John, simple question. What started out so well for the Bears went so wrong so fast in the second period.
Yeah, Andrew, let's talk about what went right first in the first period after Todd Nelson said it wasn't Hershey Bears hockey in game one. It definitely was in the first period. Outshot them 15-5. What I really liked about the first period is they got to the interior. They got the forecheck going. A lot of penalties early on, and that was on both sides in the first period. Obviously, penalties, the huge downfall for Hershey in the second. Dylan McElrath been to the box four times. I got to tell you, I'm not a big fan of all the penalties. The Bears have taken some for sure. I don't think eight would have been the number they should be at. I didn't particularly think the penalty shot would have been, but it should have been a penalty. They did have a bit of an unforced error on the third Coachella goal where Dylan McElrath came out of the box, and it looked like from our side that Vinny Iorio was supposed to make the jump. He didn't. That kept the 5-on-4 going for a little too long, and I think that's a real pivotal point in this game because that made it 3-0, and the barn door kind of got open and the horse got away.
Two circumstances coming together. First, McElrath going off, and then it'll bounce off the boards and deflect it out into no man's land right there. Now the question is, it's 4-0. Do you go to Zach Fucale here in the final third
period?
Yeah,
you absolutely have to, and that's no indictment of Hunter Shepard at all, but you cannot let Hunter out there for the third period when all the shots and all the momentum's going downhill. Hunter Shepard has been a terrific goaltender this entire playoff run. At least give him the third period to recoup, get ready for game three at Giant Center, and go from there. And a lot of times you'll see coaches, you want to pull them just to light a spark, and it's a big mountain to overcome here in the third period. We don't want to sugarcoat that, but you need a spark. You need something to change, and the goaltending, sometimes that's the one you do. We'll see if it happens. I like what we saw in the first period. It's going to be tough to kind of get back into that after what happened in the second period. You can't take eight penalties, even if some of them were a little bit, I don't know, but eight is still a big, big number through two periods. The penalty shot as well. You've got to keep your sticks down. You've got to stop taking the infractions if you can and then try and regroup after that.
Got to find something to try to tilt the ice in the Bears' favor, if not for this game, as they go back to Hershey for the next three. We've seen this before, getting down 2-0. Not the death kill that Hershey knows how to come back. They've done it before in the Calder Cup Finals. When we come back, Zach Fisk and I, we go through the first two period stats here in game two of the Calder Cup Finals. You're watching Hershey Bears Hockey here on Fox 43.
After the game tonight,
let's ride together.
So I can bring any car into Orsman Chantilly Toyota, and they'll buy it?
That's what they just said on TV.
Doesn't matter what year, make, or model.
No.
And I can get Kelley Blue Book for it?
More, 125%.
And if I buy a new car, I'll get their buyer's edge with $1,500 in bonus extras?
Yes.
I find that very hard to believe.
Ugh.
And don't forget, at Orsman, we'll buy any car. Orsman Chantilly Toyota. Let's ride together.
This right here is the extra large New York style pizza from Papa John's. And in order to make a big, tasty, extra large New York style pizza like this, you gotta really hand stretch that fresh, never frozen dough made from only 6 simple ingredients. Like this. Woo! Look at that. That's what makes a Papa John's extra large New York style pizza Papa John's. Better ingredients, better pizza, but you knew that.
My grandfather was a Ukrainian immigrant. He lived in this DC row house and owned a tailor shop. My father managed a toy store down the street after he returned from World War II. They both loved the Washington region and taught me to serve our community. That's why my law firm, Greenberg & Vetterman, has helped thousands of people in the District, Maryland, and Virginia for over 35 years. We're here to help you, our neighbors and friends, as we have done with care for so long. Greenberg and Betterman. Contact us. Feel better.
At Jiffy Lube, it's our job to keep you moving. With a full range of services from oil changes and tire rotations to filters, wipers, and more, we've got what your car needs right when you need it, so you're ready for whatever's next. Putting you in the driver's seat of car care? That's a job for Jiffy. At Jiffy Lube, it's our job to make car care make sense with personalized service reviews that swap the car talk for straight talk, so you know what your car is telling you and what to do about it. Putting you in the driver's seat of car care? That's a job for Jiffy.
Redesigned from the ground up and engineered for adventure, the all-new Tundra is Toyota's toughest, most advanced truck to date, outfitted to help tackle any terrain with reliability only Toyota is known for. Now electrified with available iForce Max powertrain and one of the top 10 vehicles with best resale value according to KBB.com. Toyota, let's go places.
Firebirds have a 4-0 lead going into period number three. Thanks to John Walton for joining us. Grant Fuhr as well. Great individual and pleasure to get a chance to chat with him. The Firebirds have 1 minute and 15 seconds of carryover power play time to start the third period of play. And for the Hershey Bears, you know what, for me right now, look, hey, maybe you pull off an absolute miracle and score five of the third, probably pretty unlikely. Coachella Valley and shut the Hershey Bears down. For me, it's just scoring, getting that confidence. You're going back to Chocolate Town. You got three. Take care of business in your own barn, but get some momentum, get some confidence, find a way to beat Joey DeCore.
Yeah, the players don't care about stats and who takes game one and who takes game two. Obviously, you want to split, but you got to get some momentum going somehow, some way, and find it. If that's Zach Fucali coming in, making a couple great saves and lighting a spark, so be it. You got to find something.
Yeah, got to find something in the third period of play. Best period. You need this to be your best period. You need to beat DeCord to get some confidence. See if the Bears can do that in the third period. That around the corner. Stay with us. 4-0 Firebirds. Great to have you along, even if it hasn't been the ride we wanted yet. You're tuned in to the 2023 Calder Cup Finals.
Lather up the sunscreen and throw on the shades because super hot summer savings are here at Oarsman Chevrolet of Bowie. During the summer sales event, get a hot deal on a new Chevy from Oarsman Chevrolet of Bowie. With financing as low as 3.9%. And we'll buy your car even if you don't buy from us. Offering up to 130% of Kelley Blue Book value. Don't miss the hot deals all summer long.
Remember, you always get your way at Oarsman Chevrolet of Bowie.
America is blessed with countless servicemen and women who have bravely fought on our behalf. They've paid the price in body and spirit so we can enjoy our freedom.
By joining the military during a very active period of war, I absolutely went into it with the idea that I could die. Both my legs were amputated due to an IED that I sustained while I was deployed to Iraq. I mean, I'm still here, so there must be something more.
Far too many struggle to get the care and benefits they earned through service and sacrifice. Disabled American Veterans is a lifesaver for our injured heroes. They help service members of all ages get the help they need, but they can't do it alone.
There were moments of frustration where you can't do this anymore, you can't go here anymore. I absolutely felt like I lost some of my purpose.
I'm asking you to join me and other patriotic Americans and donate only $19 a month, just 63 cents a day. Your monthly donation will help veterans like Nick Kolchar. For 100 years, DAV, Disabled American Veterans, has been fighting to keep our promises to our injured heroes each and every day, ensuring that our sons and daughters get the care and assistance they deserve. You'll help them get the financial and medical benefits they've earned and receive the care and emotional support they need. When you call or go online right now with your pledge of just $19 a month, we'll send you this DAV blanket as a way you can share your support of our brave veterans. Join me and other patriotic Americans and support DAV. For only $19 a month, just 63 cents a day, you can say thank you in the most meaningful way. Please, call or go online to helpdav.org and donate now. Thank you, and God bless you.
The third period of Hershey Bears hockey on Fox 43 is presented by Pocono Mountain Visitors Bureau.
Back for sure, arena the site tonight. The Firebirds lead the Bears 4-0. They'll start with 1:15 of carryover power play time with Andrew Kalista. I'm Zach Fish, producer Ed Albert alongside. Thanks for being with us here. We'll get back to the sweetest place on earth next week. Sunning time in Hershey, PA. Great concerts coming in, including Zach Brown Band and Big Time Rush in the month of July. Luke Bryan, Jason Aldean too. But June, the Bears are still playing. That's a good thing. But for me, they just got to leave it all on the line here. Set the tone, have their best period of the series. Beat Joey DeCore. That's mission number one. Gain some momentum for game number three if you're not going to pull off a miraculous comeback. We have seen it before the NHL level. It is a mountain to climb, and is probably not one that you're going to be able to say the least, but never count out this Bears team, and I'm not doing that by any means, but right now they haven't scored yet in the finals. Just one would be a start.
Got to find something. As Billy Joel said, can't start a fire without the spark, Fish.
I like that little Billy Joel reference. But a faceoff to the left of DeCord. Sutter backed off in the circle, checking the clock here as well. In the third period, the Bears were outscored 3-0 in game number one. And the playoffs, Hershey outscoring opponents 20-11 in the third period of play. So look at it positive in that. They had pretty good third periods, but did not hit pay dirt in game one. As DeCord looking for his second consecutive and third shutout of the playoffs. Up the far ring, McElrath will knock it down. Farson boards. It's Cartier with it. Snicked out by Sutter. That's good work there by Riley. He gets it all the way down the ice. Always count on a reliable, honest, hardworking effort from 24 in the white sweater, Riley Sutter. And his best season as a Bear this year. Ponorowski to center. Hughes with that gorgeous goal there. Hard to believe that was his first goal of the playoffs. He had a ton of assists, but no goals. And he just cut through everybody. Pilon the other way. Down the left wing. Bolting in offensively. Down a man. Pilon to the middle. Off the tape of Lucas Johansson. Threw it to the net front. Off the stick of McMichael. And up in the air, the Firebirds have it. Ponorowski down the left wing. Defended well by Iorio, who steps up. Pilon with the steal, tired. Will deflected back to center. And the Firebirds' 8th power play comes to a close. They're 2-for-8 in this game. True to the net front. Hunter Shepard stays in goal to start the third period. Thought they might go to Zach Fucali. And again, that is nothing against Shepard. But sometimes coaches will switch goaltenders to change momentum. We saw Shepard having a bit more of an off night in game one against Rochester. Changing goaltenders to put Fucali in. He's only played that one game. It was perfect in relief, but sticking with the number one guy in Shepard. Frank over the blue line. Love him to get one. He'll shoot, stick save, DeCord. And the fans applaud DeCord snatching the puck out of the air.
They love their goalie here in Coachella Valley. Doesn't matter if it's a flashy save or just routine.
The old adage is right, the series is not over until you lose a home game. Well, the Bears, and the way the HL set up, 2-3-2. Bears fans remember, now it's a different story. I'm just throwing out a thought. 2010, both were at Giant Center. The Bears lost both of them. And when they draw here, it's Nass at the left point. Wrist shot to the net, deflected wide. That 2010 team was lethal. You could always count them to come back. But Bears lost both games, 1-2, in Chocolate Town. And they went on the road and won 3 in a row. So I'm just saying, even if you go down 0-2, the 3 games, this time it's in your own building, you could come back to this building for game 6 up 3-2 if you take care of business at home. Again, baby steps, because you need to get one first on DeCord, and you love it to come here the next 17:35. If anything, just to make him feel like, okay, I'm not completely unbeatable, because right now, as icing is called, he probably feels invincible, and as he should, because that's what he's been.
He's been aggressive through 2 games. Dazzling as he handles the puck.
and he's playing with a lot of confidence.
We got a correction to your Billy Joel, Bruce Springsteen. Bruce Springsteen, that was him.
Ooh.
A little music reference. The puck goes up and out of play. Credit where credit is due to the Twitterverse for catching that one.
Billy Joel is We Didn't Start the Fire.
There we go.
There we go.
Firebirds, they're fired up.
I was born in the 80s, I'm sorry.
Face off at center. They're both good songs.
Tremendous.
Start the face off again.
To make up for it, I'll put a red baseball cap in my back pocket next game.
I will say the Bears have won more when you have been ice-side, Andrew, if you want to believe in jinxes. It's not your fault. It doesn't matter, but...
Zach, that
is, it's just a fact. It's just a fact. That's what we talk about, facts here on the broadcast. Puck is bounced into Cord. We'll play it behind the net. Snively with a hit on Witko, knocked him off balance. Puck kept in McMichael in the feet, though, of Pilon for the far corner. Connor McMichael with it on the right side, half board. So the blue line, shot deflected in front to Cord. The save, rebound. Oh, where did he get that one? Pilon denied. It looked like he was going to punch in the second effort. Not a good recipe for success with a finish. Again, just comes up a bit short. Puck dumped into Cord. We'll leave it behind the goal. Schultz to take it behind his own net. Bears have not necessarily always gotten the rebounds in this game. Chela Valley's done a good job boxing out in front of their own goal. That time, Piedlon got the chance. I think it might have hit the goal stick of Decor to deflect it wide. Falling down was Anna as the puck shot in down the ice. Should be icing, and it is as the Bears go back for it. 4 minutes after the witching hour, it is now a new day in Central PA. Let's pause 10 seconds. Radio sign for station identification for our listeners on the Highmark Bears Radio Network. LaPierre thrown out of the circle. Alexei Protis in to win that duel. Johansson in the net off the left pad of Decor. Comes to Iorio. Smashes a shot that gets deflected wide along the near wing. Played to center. Cleared on the way down. Shepherd is out to stop it. And leave to Iorio back in the lineup tonight. Panis falls down. Worked in by Podorowski. Trying to curl and drag. And Iorio made him up. Deflected the puck away. Puck clear down the ice. This will be icing on the Bears. Three goalposts back of the first. Some defensive miscues and penalty trouble in this first and second. Has been the undoing of the Bears here tonight. In Coachella Valley, tip your cap to them. This is a Bears broadcast, but we will always give credit where credit is due. Seen a couple of gorgeous goals for them. A little puck luck like on the knuckler on the third tally. They've got the mojo in swagger right now here in this barn, looking for their sixth consecutive win. Face off to the right of Shepherd, won cleanly by the Firebirds to the far wing. LaPierre is able to knock it loose and look to take the puck. He does that to Alexei Protis to center. Iorio tries to join the rush, but the puck squirts away from him. Misa Morelli looking to knock it loose. There for the Bears is Protis. Trying to jam it free on the fireside boards. Out of the pile that comes in Coachella Valley with possession is Morelli on top of Riker Evans. They'll separate. Rafferty in offensively. Finds the man on the left. Lynn shot. That's a quality stop by Shepherd. Sliding to his right, anticipating and robbing Cole Land of the one-time slap shot goal.
Looked very similar. I believe the fourth goal from game number one. This time Shepherd goes post to post, reads it well, and doesn't give up the rebound.
Shepherd stands it ready. Game three of the series will be Tuesday at Giant Center. Still are some tickets available, but very limited seating. If you haven't got yours, you're going to want to get them.
Bears need the fans on their side. The Bear Nation will be ready to roar as they always are. The best, most passionate, dedicated, loyal, and intelligent fans in the AHL is icing his call to the Firebirds. You know the Bears fans will be ready to cheer their team to hopefully a bounce back performance in game three. We wanted it tonight, but this one is out of a game as we see to the playoffs. Just for a variety of reasons, but Firebirds' opportunistic tendencies have again been the storyline. Everyone backs off of the circle. Torinsky and Sunder to take the draw. Riley wins it cleanly to the far corner. Shot in front of the Bears bench. This will be another icing on Hershey as the puck goes all the way down for a faceoff coming up in the Bears defensive zone. Bears fans, Bo Cable, looking at the Mayo, has upgraded their optical lab. They're now offering in-house digital lenses, most accurate lenses in the world. Bring us your prescription, we'll fill it. Using the most accurate state-of-the-art processing, ensuring the best possible vision. From sunglasses to surgery, BMD is your one-stop eye care facility. Two offices in Cleone and Elizabethtown. Check them out at bmdi.com. Been a busy night. We've not seen any minors here so far in the first 5 minutes and 15 seconds of period three. Carson Torinsky on the right side half boards. He'll dip the puck behind the goal. Here to cut it off is Riley Sutter. To Dale on the far wing. To center ice, it's Stein up in the air. Loved by Schultz. Malenstein tries to poke it away from him. Oh, big collision. Morelli took a stick up high from Schultz, but the penalty call is coming up on the Bears. Mason Morelli will head to the penalty box. Firebirds hand to power play nine. Here's a look at it. Morelli went for the hit. Wound up going leg on leg with Schultz. Wound up taking the worst of it. He got caught in the mouth.
It's a familiar sight that we've seen, a Bear being escorted to the box.
Well, as we talked about it, again, the officials, you can say what you want about them. I certainly think the standard has been different. It's been frustrating, but we sent it the first. This is the way they appear to be calling it. You have to adjust, and unfortunately, the Bears just have not been able to adjust. They've adjusted so many things well in the playoffs, but they have not been able to stay out of the box tonight. And there certainly are a few chintzy ones in my mind. And talking to others here, even on the Coachella Valley side, they agreed with that. Not sure Bears fans are none too pleased elsewhere. Alas, you gotta deal with the circumstances and find a way to dig deep. The Bears will look to do that on the penalty kill once more. Sent in by Bokeh Mulligan to Mayo as the puck is shot in behind the Bears' net. McElrath is after it along the far wing. Back at the point. Right side, Ponorowski is wrist shot, deflected down wide of Shepard. As the goaltender sprawled out as he went to the corner. Charles Valley works the perimeter. 13:45 left of the third period. They're up 4-0 here in game two. Looking to take a 2-0 series lead, getting business done in both games at home. Flexion played the middle, far wing. Pull in, will pull back. Far side board. Top prospects of the Kraken. Sees it come out to center. Coachella Valley will regroup with Riley Sutter causing a steal. Looking for a shorthanded dandy. His shot deflected wide of the goal. Never made it to the court, who stopped all 26. The Bears have thrown his way thus far. Hershey in danger of being blanked for the third consecutive game in the Calder Cup Finals, dating back to the Game 4 series decider in 2016. That irrelevant to this year's team, but still, I know Bears fans would love to see their team light the lamp in the finals. Puck shot, far side, waffle boarded away by Shepard to steal a line from the great broadcaster Doc Emmerich, big fan of Hershey, PA. And I'm sure following these finals, the NHL tonight, Chandler Stephenson, former Bear, had two. Vegas took a 3-1 series lead over the Florida Panthers. ECHL, that has ended. Florida Everblades repeat their back-to-back champions, taking down the Idaho Steelheads. So, only four teams left playing in professional hockey. Bears are one of them, and despite the result tonight, that's got to make you smile. If they want to keep playing, they're going to have to find a way to use the home crowd to their advantage to right the ship with potentially three next week at home.
Power play is over. The Bears come up with it. Still down by four. 12:05 left in the game. Puck is knocked away in front of the benches. Ness off balance. It's Terinsky to play it ahead. On the rear wing, it's Pettman skating it back behind the goal. Well defended by Day. Puts his muscle into him. And Frankel on the far wing looks to skate to center. Knocked off the puck. Ethan back in the lineup tonight. Had that one good chance on the power play. And hit the post. Vecchione shot wide of DeCord. Right point McElrath deflected to the corner behind the net. Horkstrom looking to dig it loose and clear down to center. Horkstrom looking to wheel it to Vecchione. He can't find it. 11:20 left in the third period of play. Firebirds 4, there's nothing. So much hard work put in all season long to get to this point. You know the Bears are going to have a bad taste in their mouth coming home after these couple of games. It's Carlson to center though. Trying to right the ship to the near wing. Pass out of the reach of Annis. Turned over to Winko behind the net. Chella Valley up by four. Andrew has done a good job just not giving the Bears much space on the rush.
Locking down defensively, making sure not to give up any easy ones. No odd man rushes. When you have a four-goal lead, though, it's easy to pack it in.
Lucas Johansson will await behind his own net and slowly creep forward. Overskated by Iorio. He'll dump it beneath the goal line, and Johansson there as the Bears looking to complete a line change. Pilon, McMichael, and Snively are out there up the middle to Connor McMichael, knocked away from him. And played back defensively by the Firebirds. Come to see the top six be the ones to come up with a goal to get the Bears on the board here. Those are important players if Hershey's going to come back in this series. Let him led the charge offensively. No Scarbosa, obviously, still out with an injury. Would love to get his services back, but doesn't seem probable, at least with him not playing since round one. On the right wing, the Bears working offensively. 9:40 to go in period number three. It's out to center to Jesper Froden. He's got goals in both games here in the finals. Rattled in by Hughes. Behind the net is Shepard. Will slow the tempo. Carlson to the far wing looking for Day. And the puck played behind the net. O'Reilly center to take it. And break to center. Morelli with it at the red line. Will shoot it in behind the goal. Malenstein on the forecheck. Throws the hit and it pops free to the right wing. McElrath up the boards. Left side. Lucas Johansson to the middle. Mason Morelli. Dropped on back to center. His shot. DeCord's got it. Maze of players in front. He's got the remedy again. 9:01 left in game two. 4-0 Firebirds. Stay with us. You're tuned into the 2023 Calder Cup Finals.
Good vision is essential. That's why I try.
NBC Sports Washington is your home in the District of Champions.
My biggest fear in the middle of my addiction was that I would never be able to get over it and that my kids wouldn't have a father. I started thinking, you know what? This isn't my story. For the longest time, fear held me back from ultimately being who I wanted to. I had to become a better man to be a better father. It's important to me that my kids are empowered and truly believe that if they can think it, they can do it.
If you're like me, you'd rather talk about basketball or anything other than prostate cancer. But we can't be silent when it comes to our own health. Prostate cancer affects 1 in 8 men in the U.S. I beat it because I was screened and it was detected early. Prostate cancer is often passed on through families. The NBA and the Prostate Cancer Foundation are asking you and your loved ones to know your risks and get screened. Go to pcf.org/get screened to learn more.
4-0 Coachella Valley, the Firebirds leading the Bears. Bears fans, a reminder from our friends at Penn State Health, their goal is to keep the people of Central PA healthy so they live the way they want. This is why they continue to innovate, expand, and invest in the conditions they treat and the people they care for right here close to home, Penn State Health. Penn State Health, the sponsor of the Bears 2023 playoffs.
Andrew Kalista, I'm Zach Fish. Andrew will join us ice side for game number three as Konsanowski will rejoin us in the booth, playing a little bit of hooky, and maybe he'll bring us some good luck back and get you down there interviewing guys after some big goals and success, Andrew.
Well, he was texting me just during that commercial break, asking what is going on. Of course, that's a rhetorical question as he's watching the game.
To center ice, it's Lucas Johansson with it. Stretch pass, far wing. Frank will knock it in to the left corner. Borgstrom digs it loose. Roll to the point. On edge, the puck sits flat now. Frank to take it, plays it to himself behind the goal. Up the perimeter of the boards, Nash seals it. Then comes to the point to Frank again. Double clutches and shoots, deflected in front of DeCord. Frank let it go, grimacing a little bit as he shoots and playing around behind the net. Borgstrom, good work, knocks it free. Right circle, Borgstrom shot DeCord again with the blocker, punches it out, an aggressive challenge. And to the corner it goes. Firebirds to the red line. He'll shoot it in. Dane to lead behind the net with 7:40 left in the third period. If necessary, game 6 and 7 would be back in this building. 3 coming up at Giants Center. Game 5 is still necessary. A loss tonight, unfortunately, for Hershey would assure that they would have to win to be coming back here if they wanted to win the Calder Cup this year, as the puck rolls in on DeCord. Better way of saying that, Firebirds take a 2-0 series lead. That would be the case if they get the win tonight. Take a breather, be back. This is the 2023 Calder Cup Finals.
Stroman Bakeries, the makers of Stroman.
This may look like an action-adventure movie, but it's a Nissan sales event ad. Things are heating up. Good thing this Rogue has the most standard safety features in its class. Our competitors can't say that.
Now get a low $299 per month lease on Rogue.
Hurry. These epic offers won't last forever.
Don't freak out, but you can get 50% off all menu-priced Domino's pizzas when you order online right now.
Right now?
Right now.
Right now?
Right now?
Right now.
50% off, honey! Right now!
Now through the end of the week, get 50% off all menu-priced pizzas when you order online at Domino's.
Success looks different for everyone, which means the path to success also looks different. For 75 years, University of Maryland Global Campus has helped adults succeed. You're not waiting to win. You're ready to succeed again at umgc.edu.
Hello to our fans that are still with us in Aruga as the Bears watch party. Thanks to them for cheering the Bears on despite the result. We're going to need the Bear Nation back in Chocolate Town. Remember, the party on the plaza starting at 3. Tickets do remain very limited for games 3, 4, and 5. Off the faceoff, the puck comes free and cleared all the way down the ice. McElrath going back for it. And icing is called on the Bears. Haven't seen a ton of Mac here in the third period. Tough night with the four minors, but the Bears captain has been here, done that. And will be ready to lead his team in game 3. Coming up here on Tuesday night in Chocolate Town. If you bought tickets before the series schedule is announced, use tickets for Calder Cup Finals, round 5, home game 1. For home game 1, bigger pardon, but home game 1 is the one you want. Corners of the steal at center. Hannes darts ahead, looking to get one. Hannes down the left wing, cuts in, shot it wide. Trying to go over the blocker of DeCorn. 3-on-2 up ice, Coachella Valley. Lynn to True, good breakup. McElrath taken down to the corner as the puck off the boards. Indirectly, bend to the blue line, Evans. Riker Evans wheels it around the net. To Lynn, pass wasn't on the mark. Bears break it up, good defensive play to center. Stolen by True again. Along the near wing. True off the stick of Shepherd. The Bears goaltender got a piece of it. As the puck sits loose in front, Lynn denied. Only Shepherd and Lynn knew where it was. Shepherd a quality save and tight. Everybody ramming into each other right now. Puck broken in hand. McMichael rushing offensively down the left wing. Shoots off the left shoulder to Korn. Just got a chunk of it. Puck comes loose to the slot. The Bears whistle the net. Snively once, twice blocked. Delon will cut in. Last circle to the far corner. Nance to the point with traffic. Want to get one here. Nance behind the net. Leaves for Garrett Pilon. Down by four. Pokes the puck in front. Broken out by the home team and the Firebirds. 2-on-2 to center. Overskated by Podorowski. He'll spin it on back. Three players collide. Two Bears and Podorowski. And Podorowski goes off holding his mouth. That was Anil and might have even been friendly fire from his own stint. Tough to tell. Marvin Moy. To center ice. Malenstein to deflect it in. The Cord gets a little fancy with the puck and played up the middle of the center. As good as the puck handle is early in the game, the Bears did a really good job keeping it away from him. That'll continue to have to be a point of emphasis the rest of the way, however long this series may go. We know if the Firebirds take this one tonight, the point I was trying to get to before I went to break to the series, if Hershey were to win it, would at least have to go six. Which would mean they would not be able to win it at home, but right now just focusing on trying to beat DeCole. Left circle, Frank shots, save DeCord. Oh, Markstrom at the top half of the net. He sailed it up and over the goal. McElrath tied up. Hayden beat him to it. Hayden down the wing. McElrath gets back to take it away. Gabriel Carlson is center with 4:15 left in this one. It's Vecchione behind the net. DeCord to play it behind the goal. Up to center ice. Stay with it for Hershey. Bears in danger of being blanked for a second consecutive game by DeCord. He only had one shutout in the postseason coming in. Ford pops it to the far corner for Evans. Off the skate of a Firebird to center. Rafferty rolls out. LaPierre ahead. 2-on-1. Protus down the left wing. Off the glove of DeCord. And up and out of play. DeCord has been masterful. 3:36 left. 4-0 Firebirds. This is the 2023 Calder Cup Finals.
Hey Bears fan, Fox 43 Sports.
The best Capitals coverage starts here. Only on NBC Sports Washington. Your home of the Washington Capitals. Let's go Caps.
Hello, innovation. Goodbye, injuries. Hello, science. Goodbye, seizures. Hello, tiny incisions. Goodbye, lengthy recoveries. At Children's National Hospital, we're making breakthroughs daily so we can say hello to a healthier future for kids.
Hi, I'm Katie from Long Roofing. For four generations, we've helped families just like yours bring beauty, value, and comfort to their homes. Our professional and customer-focused process will ensure that you protect your home for decades to come. Call now to get no payments and no interest for a full year, plus $1,500 off. Get your free estimate today, and you'll see we do roof replacement the right way, the long way. Isn't it time you got
along? 3:36 left in this one. Zach Fish alongside Andrew Calista and Albert, our producer. Appreciate all his hard work here. Art, Trey Seaback of the Bears Radio Network Studios. Tip of the cap to the technical crew here at Coachella Valley. They worked hard to improve the broadcast quality and hope that was apparent with that main game camera here. They gave us the feed here and worked with them to get that rectified and up and running. Looking forward to working with the great Saint Productions. Televise all the games. Games 3, 4, and 5 will be back home at Giant Center, all on TV. Check our schedule at HersheyBears.com. Some on Antenna TV, some on Fox 43. It's down behind the play is true. Did not see what happened to him. Our vision is blocked along the boards, but he is laying flat on his belly and not able to get up. Alex True is down and in pain. As you see right there, laying on the ice and talking
to Max McCormick as the training staff of the Firebirds comes out. Head trainer Brent Bernstein. Here's a look at it. Oh, he was hurt before he got bumped in the pylon. It looked like he came up limp skating there. Pulled something, potentially. It looks like he's holding his lower back there, maybe. Not sure if he spasmed or has a further issue. He's able to skate off with a little bit of help, but in some pain. True heads down the tunnel and into the dressing room. Another look at it, and they're showing the contact here.
He kind curls up before pylon even brushes up against them. It was minimal contact.
The last look, he grimaced before he got hit. So I think even though, you know, his legs move because of the impact, because here's Snively in down the left wing. I think it was initially maybe the left side that was an issue there. Regardless, nothing malicious that anyone should be crying foul on. Poganski down the right wing. He had a goal in this one tonight. And the wave is being started again with 3 minutes left in a 4-0 game. This atmosphere is different from really anything that I've seen at the American Hockey League level. You know what? All the credit in the world to the folks here in Palm Desert for creating a good one. But it is a hockey game within kind of a party-like atmosphere. And some of the folks and their staff helped start the Vegas Golden Knights and similar in game presentation on the scaled down level. Pre-game with the Fire shooting out. Puck jumps in behind the Anna Schemper. 2:30 left in this one. Johansson to the far corner. Iorio, puck knocked loose away from him. Spinning shot, Cartier, and Shepard is there, rolls back to him. He will fall on top of it. Tomorrow, the Bears will fly home in the morning. Charter flight back to Chocolate Town. Appreciate everybody that helped put that together. No easy task, especially last minute. And then home cooking's gonna be needed. The Bears have not necessarily been fantastic at home in the playoffs, but in the regular season, they were dialed. They're going to rely on the Bear Nation to help will them back in this series. So we need you, Bears fans. Keep the faith. It's certainly frustrating. It's certainly discouraging. And it's certainly worrying. I mean, no doubt. It's only natural to be worried. Uh-oh, the Bears are in trouble here. They've been outscored as Frank smoked. Outscored 9-0 in the playoffs so far. And still trying to come up with a solution to Coachella Valley's goaltender. So trying to come up with a solution to how to shut down this potent offense. Is there a reason to be worried? Sure, but you don't really have a series being completely pointed is over until you lose your home game. The Bears got three of them coming up. Control their own destiny in that sense, or the fact that they can take care of business. Puck dumped in back behind the goal. McElrath steps up, throws a hit. Puck bouncing in on Decor, and he will cover it. Now with a minute 26 left, I think McElrath's probably going to just go ahead and get himself a fifth penalty for the sheer fact that the game is out of hand and over at this point, except the score. And this is more to set the tone a little bit.
I was going to say, it's at that point where if you're not going to put one through Joey Decord as he flips the puck up and down in his glove outside of this replay, what does it take to find that spark and that fire?
Dylan McElrath's night is going to be over. I think it's just a 10-minute misconduct here. The faceoff has not gone outside the zone. Draw should probably at least go to center here. It's McElrath, the defenseman, engaged. Yeah, it's going to go in the dot right in front of the Firebirds bench in neutral. So McElrath going to pick up an additional penalty. It won't be a minor, but his fifth penalty of the game and a 10-minute misconduct. Weird bounce off the stanchion. Comes free to the point for Hershey. And it's right side. Shot deflected wide of Decord. And Brodus looking to knock it free. Quick go behind the net along the far wing. Lifts it to center. Gave LaPierre a cross check, and LaPierre didn't like that. Minute left, fans to their feet here in the desert.
Cartier over the blue line to the right wing. Pentman will dump it back behind the Hershey goal. Back Malenstein ahead to center. Chipped in by Lee, chugging along after it. Interfered with the bit. Skates right through it. The center ice it goes. 25 to play here tonight. The series will shift back to Hershey. Get your tickets. Help get the Bears back in the series on home ice. Iorio going to go coast to coast. Evans buries him. 13 seconds left. To Chella Valley. Back to back. Joey DeCore covers it. And a penalty call here. Now it's going to get nasty. Valenstein took down a Firebird. Penalty call coming up. Johansson screaming. And Hayden, Iorio's lost his helmet. 3.3 to go. The officials might have their hands full before we're done.
Morelli just took a, before that, took a cross check right to the back of his helmet, which kind of started it all.
Johansson sent down the tunnel. Now on the clock. At this point, I'm sure the officials wish that they would have just run it out. With that much time, not an option. Officials are going to chat. It's all over but the final score here because everybody was involved. The draw will go to center. Barring a quick shot off the faceoff, DeCord is going to pick up back-to-back shutouts. And I'm sure the American Hockey League will rifle through the record book to tell you the last time that occurred in the playoffs. For the Bears, they'll go home scratching their heads and dig in deep with their season on the line at home. They must win game three to make it a 2-1 series and get back in it. 4-on-4 with 3.9 to go. Face off in neutral. See if we can get through this without any shenanigans. Firebirds take it, skate it back in their own zone, and that is it. Coachella Valley, a 4-0 shutout. They take a 2-0 series lead, and Joey DeCord blanks the Bears for the second consecutive game. Hershey heads back to Chocolate Town, USA. Games 3 and 4 in their own barn, and if necessary, game 5. And they're going to better hope home cooking will will them back into the series. The Firebirds show why they have all the firepower with 2 big wins on home ice.
Bears have to find an answer going home. Tonight, the flight to regroup. Can't stress enough how much not only the home ice, but the home beds over the next 5 days are important.
Everyone will experience the time change going back. Let's look at our 3 stars of the game, sponsored by Bud Light. Easy to drink, easy to enjoy. Goal and assist for Riker Evans. Goal and assist for Cameron Hughes. Pretty goal. And Joey DeCord with the shutout. 33 saves, your number one star tonight. As the fans are still screaming and making noise here in Coachella Valley.
That's their number one interest. The hockey comes second, the noise is first here, and the hockey's giving them a lot of reason to make the noise.
Their team is 2 wins away in their inaugural season from hoisting the Calder Cup. But if the Bears have shown us anything this year, you can't count them out. We thought they'd respond today. It just didn't happen. Plain and simple. Game 3, Tuesday at Giant Center. We'll have the broadcast. Todd Sadowski rejoins Andrew and I. Stay with us. Radio sign for Fairview Golf Course post-game coverage. As Art Selby back in the studio, we'll bring us that with myself, Zach Fish. 33 save shutout for Joey DeCord. The Bears come up empty-handed in games 1 and 2 in California. Back to Chocolate Town on Tuesday night. Till then, the Bears will get back to work. And we'll talk to you next.